welcome to Mack Tharp Stadium. They call it the Hog Pen in Moultrie for another Football Friday in Georgia tonight. It's the Region 1 7A championship game as the number 6 Lowndes Vikings meet the number 7 and two-time defending state champion Colquitt County Packers. As we take a look at the region standings, you can see the math is simple. Win tonight, you're the region champion and a number 1 seed in the state playoffs that begin 2 weeks from now. The loser will be the runner-up and a number 2 seed. And good evening. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by the legendary Big Chuck
thank
Smith.
Thank you. Thank you. Come on, man. That's too much. That's too much.
This is the 41st all-time meeting between these two South Georgia rivals, and they don't like each other very much. In the first decade of the 2000s, Lowndes won 7 region titles and 3 state championships. That's before Rush Probst got to Moultrie, and the Packers have won 2 straight state titles. They currently have the region championship trophy. They want to keep it. Lowndes wants to take it back with them.
Well, Lowndes hasn't won one since 2010, so they're starving. They're hungry. They're trying to eat. Now, Colquitt, they're trying to go for number 3, and with this crowd being electric like it is, they got a home field advantage.
Well, we have the top scoring offense in 7A here tonight, and it isn't the Colquitt County Packers. It's the Lowndes Vikings. They're averaging over 43 points per game, led by their junior quarterback, Michael Barrett.
Well, Michael Barrett, 18 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. That's phenomenal, especially knowing that last year he was a linebacker. He can run. That's why I call him two ways. He can run for touchdowns. He can throw for touchdowns. So when you look at Michael Barrett, he's one of the most electrifying players in the state of Georgia.
Well, Colquitt County is used to just outscoring opponents. They're going to have to get some defensive stops tonight. And during their 5-game winning streak, they've held 3 of their 5 opponents to 2 touchdowns or less. They've got some personnel on that defensive side of the ball to get it done, led by the number 2 ranked outside linebacker, junior in the country, J.J. Peterson.
Well, J.J. Peterson's number 1 in my book, and he's electrifying. He was moved from defensive end to strong linebacker so he can get pressure. They thought that was a better position for him. He's electrifying. He has to be a menace today if they're going to be effective.
And he leads the Packers with 5.5 quarterback sacks. Now, the third member of our team is John Nelson. He's going to tell you why this game is important beyond the region championship trophy.
Thank you very much, Matt. Good evening to you. Good evening, Chuck. Good evening, however you're accessing us. GPB TV, GPB.org, or the GPB Sports app. So how did we get to this time and place? Last week, Lowndes knocked off Camden to get to this undefeated point of 2-0. Last week, we go to Brody Field and show you what happened with Colquitt and Tift. A field goal by Ryan Fitzgerald, then Jay Saunders, 15-23, 236-2, 37-13, the final score there as Colquitt knocks off Tift to get undefeated 2-0 to this particular point. What does it mean tonight? You win. You probably make it to a coin flip in the quarterfinals against Grayson. You lose. You're the 2 seed. And guess what? You end up having to go to Norcross. Rush Probst said you'd have to be a lunatic to want to go to see that particular game as your second round matchup. That's what's in store tonight. 21 games decide region champs tonight, and there are a lot of placement games that are also in play. Example, St. Pius, North Oconee, we're going to kick it around the state. 2 teams at 0-8, and the winner here, if it's St. Pius, if they win 2, they could be 2-8 and make the playoffs. That's the kind of year that this has been for 2016 when it comes to a lot of teams making it to the postseason. We will kick it all night long. So, Matt and Chuck, if you would please light a very special Colquitt County candle.
Let's kick it.
It is lit. Colquitt County won the toss. They have deferred until the second half. So the Lowndes Vikings will receive the opening kickoff. There is the legendary coach of the Colquitt County Packers, Rush Probst. 91-29, now in his 9th season with the Packers. 28 seasons overall with 267 victories, 7 state titles. To his credit, 2 with Colquitt, the last 2 here in the state of Georgia, and 5 with Hoover in Birmingham, Alabama. Packed house here at the Hog Pen.
Packed house.
Packers have won 2 straight, 3 straight actually, and 4 out of 5 in the series, although Lowndes leads the overall series 24-16. Packers 42-20 winners last season. It's been a streaky series. Man, and currently, Colquitt in the middle of a long streak.
You can't fit nobody else in here. Russ Propel was right. Only the fire marshal will stop people from coming in here today. It is packed. The guys are ready. Both teams are, I'm telling you, they're fired up like I haven't seen in a long, long time.
Isaac Malagon, the senior kicker, will put it on the tee and get this game started. 29 of his 46 kicks this season have been touchbacks.
I'm watching him in the pregame. He has a leg on him. He can boot it.
Packers have won five straight since starting the season 0-4 against very tough competition.
Young team's growing up. Young team's growing up right before coach's eyes. That's what he said.
Vikings have won eight straight since their season opening loss to their crosstown rival Valdosta. And Malagon boots this one into the end zone. It will not be returned. And so the Vikings will start at their 20-yard line. That's our heads-up Georgia kickoff. Distracting driving takes lives. Michael Barrett is the starting quarterback for the Lowndes Vikings.
He's got to have a big night tonight. He's got to be able to run, and he's got to be able to make plays with his arm.
1,892 yards passing, 18 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. He averages 210 a game in the air and 78 a game on the ground. And Barrett's going to run it on the first play, and Barrett not going anywhere. Brian Merritt there to lead the charge and make the tackle along with Tyrese Barge. Here's a look at the Lowndes Vikings on offense. Four seniors on the starting offensive line led by the left tackle Tucker Barnes, who is committed to Brown. And the Vikings wide receivers and running backs, they're missing their top wide receiver Xavier Jenkins tonight. He's out with a knee injury suffered against Camden last week. He's an ESPN 3 star wide receiver. Barrett on the keeper. J.J. Peterson hops on his back along with Brian Merritt in on his second consecutive tackle. As we take a look at the Packers defensively, Nelson Lewis at defensive end, their top tackler on that defensive line. There's J.J. Peterson, the ESPN 4-star and number 2 right outside linebacker in the junior class. And Sean Schamberger, a transfer into this program with 6 offers. Auburn is leader. He is an ESPN 3-star. Barrett back to pass and throws. That is complete to Harris, and a first down for Tyson Harris down the sideline and shoved out of bounds across the 50-yard line.
Nice protection first and foremost by Lowndes. Michael Barrett has a clean pocket. Nice throw, nice catch. Spreads him out. Simple crosser across the middle.
Tyson Harris with his team leading 28th catch of the season. They spot him out at the 50-yard line. So first and 10 for the Vikings at midfield. Barrett on the keeper. No running room for Barrett that time. He runs into Nelson Lewis. Willie DeBruce was there as well.
Matt, I think they're flexing their muscle a little bit. We talked about Barrett running the ball. He's run the ball 3 times already so far. They've been running power plays, kind of flexing their muscle a little bit here against Colquitt.
He picked up 3 on the play, 2nd down and 7. Ball now across midfield at the Colquitt 47. Tisdale gets his first carry. Travis Tisdale with the first down, down to the 32-yard line before being tackled by Schamberger and also Caleb Dawson.
That's a misdirection play. Nice play, nice job by Barrett. Keeping the fake. See, what happened then, Barrett's carried the ball 3 times. When he faked it, it gave the running back an opportunity. Nice job right there by the offense.
First and 10 for the Vikings at the Packers' 32-yard line. They have moved it 48 yards since starting on the 20. Zone read, handoff goes to Tisdale. Tisdale down to the 20, and Tisdale finally touchdown saving tackle at the 10-yard line. Travis Tisdale, the sophomore tailback with 571 yards rushing on the season.
Nice setup by Tommy Watson, the run game coordinator. They've been flexing their muscle. We talked about Michael Barrett carrying the ball. Then you see that time, you see Travis Tisdale, number 6,
outside zone play was set up by earlier runs by the quarterback, Michael Barrett.
Tisdale averages 7.1 yards per carry, first and goal to go from the 9. Barrett to the air and broken up. Broken up by Willie DeBruce, and had he been able to hold on to that, Chuck, he might have been able to take that back.
Yeah, good disguise right there by the Packer defense. They were in coverage here. Had 5 in coverage sitting there. Oh, he's going to look back and say, I wish I had that if they get points. Nice job, though. Excellent job getting into your zone. That's what they were playing in. Good job, Willie DeBruce.
Second down and goal. Ball is at the 9, and the play gets blown dead.
False start. Offensive line didn't get set that time. Michael Barrett tried to up-tempo the defense. Colquitt was having problems getting the player back on the field. They had 12. Barrett tried to up-tempo the defense, and it backfired on him.
Bob Preston is our official tonight, our referee. And a timeout has been called by Colquitt County.
I think he might have waved it off.
Yeah, I think they have.
Did they wave it off?
They've spotted the ball at the 9, mm-hmm. So they have not marked off a penalty. Looks like they have waved it off. They picked up the flag.
Oh, it was movement. I'm blind.
Well,
hey, I ain't got my glasses on. But
I think what they're going to say is that Colquitt County burned
the timeout before the
penalty.
Exactly. Because they had 12 on the field. They were still fighting to get that 12th man off the field. So nice job by Coach Probst getting the guys off the field. But you had to call a timeout. He had to at that point.
Well, this Packers team started 0-4. No team has ever started a season 0-4 and won the state championship. But
this team is young.
Young.
This team is young, but remember this now. They played one of the hardest schedules in Georgia high school football history, the first 4.
Played Mill Creek, the number 1 ranked team in the state, lost to them in the Georgia Dome, lost to Plantation Florida's American Heritage here on this field, nationally televised game, lost to Tucker by 1 point, a game they lost in the fourth quarter, and then they got whipped badly by Roswell, the number 2 ranked team in the state. Barrett redirecting traffic. He's got his wide receivers on the wrong sides. Now he's got it straight. And Kyle goes in motion. They fake the sweep, and they run it right up the middle of Barrett. And Barrett down to the 2-yard line. And you see that, I mean, that kid is a solidly built kid. He's able to run that ball like a fullback.
He looked just like a fullback. I mean, he bounced off with 3 tacklers as I was watching him up the middle. I mean, he's dragging ball carries, but again, Tommy Watson, the run game coordinator, has a nice setup right now as for Lowndes. He's setting up Barrett running in the middle. Don't be surprised if he brings it back to the outside with Tisdale. That's been success on his first drive.
Third down and goal. This will be interesting. The Vikings have not kicked a field goal all season long. Let's see if they do so if they don't convert. Now they're going to face fourth down. They didn't get in.
Oh, that Colquitt defense formed a wall then.
Harris tried to dive over the line and got stopped at the line of scrimmage by Alan Key and Willie DeBruce.
We call that a noodle hit. When it hits you, you just go right down. Nice tackle.
And now a timeout has been called by Lowndes with it fourth and goal at the 1-yard line. And, Chuck, what would you do? You have not kicked a field goal all season long. In fact, you've only attempted 2.
Right.
But now here in this big game, very first drive, you're 4th and 1 at the 1-yard line.
I'm spreading them out. I'm running Barrett. I'm running Michael Barrett. He's carried us from what? This entire year?
Yeah.
I'm giving him an opportunity to run the power play right up the middle. He's had success so far in the last couple carries.
Were you surprised they handed the ball off to Harris there and not go Barrett?
Yeah, I was surprised. They had just banged him in the middle, and they've been having a lot of success with the inside zone. Then they had Tisdale go to the outside. So it surprised me a little bit they didn't go outside. But remember, it's a chess match. When we talked about matching up on both sides, they're just trying to match up.
They have
some of what you're doing now is even setting up the next series. This is a big play here.
And remember, this is an offensive line, guys, that hasn't had a holding penalty all year long. And this has always been one of the prides of Randy McPherson. He calls them the Mayflower Moving Company for a reason.
That's a big number there, Nelly. 0? I mean,
0.
It's crazy.
Look at number 61 there at left tackle. Jalen Goss, a 6'7", 250-pound junior.
T formation.
And Barrett goes up and over for the touchdown.
I'm going with my money man, and he just cashed in.
He's been doing it all year.
Michael Barrett gives the Vikings the early lead on the 11th play of the drive, an 80-yard drive. He jumps in from the one on fourth down, and Lowndes has taken a 6-0 lead.
Well, first and foremost, when you're on the road and you're in a hostile environment, you go for it here at 4th and 1 on the goal line. I'm telling you now, Randy McPherson, the head coach of Lowndes, just gave a huge infusion of confidence for his offense.
Michael Barrett with his 12th touchdown of the season, and the PAT by Colton Broom is good. And the Vikings have a 7-0 lead. Lowndes goes 80 yards the first time they touch the ball. Barrett hops over the line, and the Packers will be on offense when we get back.
Football Fridays on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations. So much more than electricity. Technical College System of Georgia. Learn more. Earn more. Cigna. Together all the way. And viewers like you. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Hog Pen. 7:55 for the first quarter, 7-0. The Mayflower Moving Company was large and in charge, going from one end of the field to the other. It is 7-0. Chuck Smith, it's time to kick it for the first time tonight. McEachern and Marietta, one of those games that could settle region action. And it's a field goal up on the board, so 3-0 early on. Big news out of Region 1-6A. Houston County with the early 6-0 lead over Northside in a must-win game for the player of the year to advance to have a possible chance of making the playoffs after week 10. More as we go back upstairs.
Thank you, Nellie. And that's maybe an early peek at a first-round opponent for either one of these teams, because in the first round, Region 1 matched up against Region 3. The number one team in Region 1, which will be the winner of tonight's ball game, would play the number 4 team. And right now it could be the Marietta Blue Devils.
And that's why you want to win today, because you don't want that situation to happen for you. I mean, no matter what, whoever wins here today, they're going to have an opportunity to host possibly a cup. They're going to get two games, and they might have a chance to get four.
Absolutely, and that's the importance of the ball game, the two guaranteed at home, provided, of course, you stay in the playoffs. And then you get a coin flip starting in the quarterfinals, mm-hmm. and you could possibly play all four, you know, at home, or you could end up like Colquitt County and lose the coin toss every week and play three on the road like they did last year. Did not prevent them from winning their second straight state championship.
And this is maybe a question for Nellie and for you later. Is this one of the greatest years for teams? I mean, there's so many great teams in that 7A.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? In that 7A, you got, I mean, Roswell, you got, I mean, even teams like Norcross that you can't, you know, sleep on when you're thinking about the playoffs, and Colquitt, you got Lowndes, you know, and I mean, this might be one of the best playoff years ever, because there's so many teams evenly matched.
Well, that's exactly what Rush Probst thinks, because when we talked to him this week, he said he felt like there were 8 teams in Class 7A that could possibly win the state title. And right now he said his vote for the best team in the state was Mill Creek.
Yep.
Thought that Roswell and Grayson had more talent than Mill Creek, but from a team chemistry standpoint, he said he would give his coach of the year vote to Shannon Jarvis, and he felt like Mill Creek was the best team right now, and they are currently the number one team in the GPB 7A top 10. Eric Paulo will kick off for the Vikings. And J.J. Peterson will take it at the 2-yard line. Fakes the reverse. And J.J. Peterson's got space across the 40. There he goes. J.J. Peterson's going to take it to the house. A 98-yard kick return by J.J. Peterson. We told you about him on defense when we started tonight. Oh, yeah, and he's on special teams, too.
Playmakers make big plays in the big games, Matt. J.J. Peterson comes downhill. I mean, he makes a couple moves, a jabber here, a step there. Nice job, but I want to tell you, Demarion Lewis, number 13, had a huge block to spring him on that play. It's a team effort.
Ryan Fitzgerald with the PAT, and we're tied at 7, just like that. Wow, what a return by J.J. Peterson. You can see why
because of that great speed, as you see the TCSG touchdown replay. This guy's an outside linebacker at the next level, or at least that's what he's projected, and he's got speed to take it back on a kickoff.
No question. I mean, excellent blocking all the way across the board. Look at Willie DeBruce, number 23. Everybody working together. Nice job. I mean, as a team effort, that's how you answer when your opponent comes into your house and scores first. Ain't nothing worse than that. But nice job, special teams answering for Colquitt.
That's a 6'2", 210-pound return man right there.
Yeah, he swole up. He got that grown man swole up. I seen him earlier, them big guns. But that's how they breed them right now in football, especially down here in Moultrie, Georgia.
Well, that was just spectacular. 98-yard return by J.J. Peterson, and just like that, we're tied again. And he's just a pup. I mean, he's still just a junior.
He ran that like a full-grown dog.
And Rush Probst says once he can get his level of commitment to the game to match the level of stardom that he's already achieved in the recruiting ranks, then he's going to be something. But that's the challenge.
It's a good way to start, though, right?
But that's the challenge. The challenge is
the challenge is
living up to the expectations, and he just did on that kickoff return. So Malagon will kick it off for the Packers.
Now we see how Lowndes responds.
Now you might have to put Fitty on the board today to win this game. Tisdale will take it. Actually, that's Harris instead. And Harris up to the 22-yard line. Tyson Harris on the return. And that's where the Vikings go back on offense. They went 80 yards the first time they touched the ball. And now they are 78 yards away from the end zone as they begin their second possession. What a great atmosphere here tonight.
I mean, this is special. This is what high school football should be about. And what a great testament to the good folks here in Moultrie. And the good folks from Lowndes.
Yeah,
they
packed it
out.
Yep.
Yep.
Lowndes High School, 52 minutes from Colquitt County High School, and they packed out their side. And Michael Barrett, look at that bull. First down carry for Barrett up to the 21-yard line. 19-yard pickup for Michael Barrett.
I mean, what am I seeing? Is this a quarterback?
Yeah.
He's a little rolling ball of thunder. I mean, he's carrying 5-6 guys. He carried the Colquitt defense another 10 yards, but the problem is the Colquitt defenders are trying to pull the ball out instead of getting them down.
Big run by Michael Barrett for the first down. Now he'll go to the air and show off his arm. It's intercepted by Schamberger. Schamberger takes it back to the 40. Tackled by Jalen Smith, but bad pass there by Michael Barrett right into the arms of Schamberger, his fourth pick of the season, and now the Packers have it again.
Well, chalk one up for defensive coordinator Bubba Walker. They've been playing a little man and sending a little pressure, but this time they go cover two. The linebacker sits back in the zone, disguise, confuses Michael Barrett. Nice job, nice disguise by the Colquitt defense.
That's just the fourth interception that Barrett has thrown all season. So first and 10, ball at the 40-yard line for Jay Saunders and the Packers offense. They go on offense for the first time tonight. And Saunders gonna swing the ball out there to Powell, Ty Powell across the 30. And Ty Powell driven out of bounds by the safety, Tymir Moore, but a big pickup for the Packers on their first snap from scrimmage.
Nice run by Powell. Great design by the Colquitt offense. A couple of fakes with the running backs and find a swing screen to the running back. Very nice design.
Ty Powell with his team-leading 35th catch of the season. And a big pop by Tymir Moore at the end of that play. So first and 10, ball is at the 20-yard line. See Saunders' numbers on the season, 12 touchdowns, 5 interceptions, 199 a game. Dejon Edwards, the freshman running back. Edwards all the way down to the 5-yard line, tackled by Tommy Owens, but a big gain by the freshman, Dejon Edwards, who was 1-2 all season long with Barrett for the rushing lead in Region 1.
Well, Dejon Edwards does a great job. Devin Holmes is a roadblock there. He gives him a little a dipsy do, and he just gets downhill fast, breaking tackles.
15-yard pickup for Edwards, who's averaging 6.2 yards per carry. He scored 10 touchdowns this season.
Yeah, he's a solid running back, going to be a big timer. Gets after it.
Edwards gets it again, and Edwards into the end zone for the touchdown. But a flag down on the play. And a holding call, going to take it back. There's a good look at Dejon Edwards right there.
Good blocking on that right side, inside zone play by Colquitt. Somebody might have got a little too many hands on him, pulling someone down.
Rush Probst shakes his head in disapproval. That takes six off the board and pulls the ball back to the 12-yard line. Pressure coming. They set up the screen for Edwards. Edwards inside the five, and he gets into the end zone unless he stepped out of bounds. Nope, they're going to rule that he stepped out of bounds.
Well-designed play there also.
Executed nicely.
Yeah. Jay Saunders did a good job of buying more time as the rush was a little slow. So kicking back, getting back, getting back, getting back to a spot. Nice job by Jay Saunders, quarterback, being patient.
Saunders going to take it himself, and Saunders gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Jay Saunders, 3-yard touchdown run, and the Packers on top 13-7.
Jay Saunders does an excellent job taking the ball and going downhill. Also chugging along, carrying a few Lowndes Vikings with him into the end zone.
Now Saunders will hold for Fitzgerald in the PAT. 14-7. A four-play, 40-yard drive following the interception by Schamberger as you take a look at the TCSG touchdown replay.
Well, Saunders, he's usually known for his passing. He has 1,793 yards, but he shows that he can also do it with his legs. Nice move there by Jay Saunders.
Third touchdown of the season for Saunders, and the Packers on top 14-7. I mean, you look at the numbers for these two offenses, and they're pretty mind-boggling. The Packers, and this is a down year for them offensively, the Packers are averaging 398 yards of total offense per game, and the Vikings are averaging 427 yards of total offense per game in high school.
And they're playmakers across the board. Well, you know, we like to go on the field before the game and kind of look at the guys and see the shapes and sizes of them. Both of these teams have grown men. Great-looking athletes on both sides, on both sidelines. And that, again, when you have those kind of athletes, as both of these teams do, you're going to be able to score some points, particularly when you're able to spread four wides out like both of these teams are with two quarterbacks that are ballers.
And number 47, who can take a kickback. He's already done that here tonight.
I see he's got the fresh haircut for the big game.
That kick will be non-returnable, so the Vikings again have to start at the 20-yard line, and we check in with John Nelson.
All right, Chuck Smith, it's time to help me out. What are we going to do now?
Let's kick it.
All right, let's kick it and show you what's going on with St. Pius and North Oconee. And guess what? The Pius defense has been coming up big so far. You had a pick six, 80 yards to the house, then another interception sets up a five-play, 53-yard drive. So St. Pius leading North Oconee 21-0. Remember, St. Pius wins out. They make the playoffs at 2-8 back upstairs.
Wow, make the playoffs at 2-8.
It's going to be a big series here for Lowndes. Right now, you see Colquitt, they're feeling themselves on offense. Lowndes got to make some moves here.
Tisdale on the carry, and Tisdale picks up the first down, 11 yards on the play. Caleb Dawson making the tackle for the Packers.
Tisdale has some power. When Colquitt, anyone's hits him, he's dragging them at least another 3 yards.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. I mean, we're talking about Barrett, and rightfully so, but Tisdale, he can bowl with the best of them.
Yeah, he can, and he's a thick one, too. Great size.
First and 10 from the 31. Michael Barrett replacing three-year starter Austin Dixon as the Vikings quarterback, played linebacker last year as a sophomore. Tisdale on the carry, and Tisdale picks up about four on the play. Nelson Lewis making the tackle for the Packers.
Got the inside zone play. He's optioning off the defensive end. If he sees the end, very disciplined, which happens here, Michael Barrett does the right thing, gives it to the running back inside the zone, inside those tackles.
I believe it was Kamari Lewis who actually hit him first. Nelson Lewis just hopped on top of him, and look at that guy just continue to motor his feet forward. He is a tough guy to get on the ground. He picks up the first down. Another big, tough run by the quarterback, Michael Barrett.
Michael Barrett's a bulldozer. When they need the surefire yards, you see what they're doing. We talked about Michael Barrett has to have a big game. Inside zone here, he decides to keep it. Fake, takes it. I mean, he's stopped right here. Again, he gets after contact. He gets almost 8 yards after contact on that play. Tough guy. Tough runner.
Vikings head coach Randy McPherson said he brings a linebacker mentality to the quarterback position, and that's already been on display here tonight. Nothing doing for Tisdale that time as he gets stopped right at the line of scrimmage by the middle linebacker, Allen Key.
Well, good job that time being disciplined. Anytime you're playing against a spread team and you got a quarterback that's optioning off something on defense, you have to be disciplined. The defensive linemen are responsible for the dive. The two inside D tackles are going to be responsible for the dive, and the inside and the middle linebacker, the defensive ends, are responsible for the quarterback. They've been banging them inside on the runs. Watch out for the outside.
So second down and 10. Pass is complete to Tavon Kyle downfield and to the 30-yard line. First catch of the night by Tavon Kyle. Remember, we told you they're without their top wide receiver, Xavier Jenkins, tonight, but Harris has had a big catch, and now Kyle has two.
Well, we talked about, hey, they keep setting them up in the inside. You got to worry about the outside. Nice job by Michael Barrett getting the ball out of his hands. Great setup. Looked like a run up here to me, but it was a pass.
26-yard pickup for Tavon Kyle. That's his per-catch average this season, which is tops on the team. The ball fired into the line of scrimmage, and it's intercepted. Nelson Lewis then fumbled the ball, and the Packers got back on top of it. So a second turnover here by the Lowndes Vikings. Nelson Lewis with the interception, and Akeem McKeever covered the fumble.
Well, anytime you get your hands up, that's an out. Well, it actually throws it off the offensive guard's back. Michael Barrett that time, as I see the replay, it goes off the offensive guard's back. Big break that time for Colquitt. Packers get one.
And actually, it was Javarius Thomas, number 18, who recovered the fumble by Nelson Lewis, and now the Packers have it at their own 32-yard line, stopping a Vikings drive in its tracks. Saunders to the air. That's a completion to the tight end, Schenker. Schenker across midfield, and Schenker finally run out of bounds at the 42-yard line. John Samuel Schenker, they are really high on this guy. They feel like if he can have a big run here in the next month, they could possibly get to the state championship game again.
Nice job by Schenker. That time he ran a slant route. Slant route lined up wide. Has a lot of range. College coaches around the country love his range and ability to line up tight as well as line up wide.
26-yard pickup for Schenker. Ball in the Vikings' side of the 50. Saunders given time to throw, and it is complete. And Torrey Ponder with his first catch of the ball game, and he gets driven out of bounds at the 35. That's a 7-yard pickup for Torrey Ponder with his 32nd catch of the season.
Lowndes is playing off of these receivers. It's an easy pitch, easy throw and catch for these wide receivers. Jay Saunders is going to pick them apart if they keep playing the zone. They're almost 10 yards off the ball.
Second down and two. That's Brent Carter. You just saw the cornerback. He's their top interception guy. They swing the ball out there to Edwards, and Edwards crashes down to the 27-yard line. And Dejon Edwards, the freshman running back, picks up the first down. As we take a look at the Packers on offense, Ian Brinson over at left tackle being recruited by Navy. Quan Stokes, the left guard, offered by UAB. And in the backfield, the freshman running back, Dejon Edwards. Head coach Rush Probst says looks a lot like Nick Chubb to him.
Yeah, he does. Built like him a little bit.
Ty Leggett goes in motion. Leggett running underneath. They throw instead for the end zone, and it's caught for the touchdown by the tight end, Josh Hadley. Josh Hadley, the tight end, just his second catch of the year, and it is a big one.
Starts off with great protection. Jay Saunders, he could have sat back there for another 5 seconds. What great protection. Every one of those offensive linemen on for Colquitt deserves credit. That was incredible protection to let the receivers get downfield. Incredible.
Fitzgerald, PAT. And the Packers, who fell behind 7-0 after the Vikings' opening drive, has scored 21 unanswered points. As you take a look at the TCSG touchdown replay, Saunders to Hadley for six.
I mean, good job by Hadley staying alive, and he has a corner route. But again, Jay Saunders doesn't have time without an incredible amount of time in the protection for this Colquitt offensive line. They have done an incredible job so far. Great job. I don't think Jay Saunders has been pressured yet. And what else can you say also? Jeff Hammond, the offensive coordinator. I'm really liking this design, Matt. I mean, this offense is really, really, really hard to figure out. Really, really well played by Jeff Hammond, offensive coordinator, setting this game plan up today.
A five-play, 68-yard drive following the interception by Nelson Lewis. And both of the Vikings' turnovers, Chuck, have turned into touchdowns for the Packers.
Yeah, and that's what Coach Probst talked about when we talked about making plays, taking advantage of your opportunities. And when you get a break, you got to take an opportunity, and you got to score. And what they've done here is got six.
Well, it was Coach Probst's belief that if you committed three turnovers tonight, you could not win the game. Well, the Vikings have already committed two here in the first quarter.
Coach Probst was talking like a prophet. All these games have been well contested except last year. But for the most part, this rivalry, I mean, it's about going back and forth. Now, the important part here, all right, you're Lowndes. You're on the road. You're still right now, you see, this team is hot. You got to figure out a way to get the momentum going back on your side.
Well, this rivalry is 4-4 since Rush Probst arrived at Colquitt County. And the Packers have won four of the last five, and the Packers have outscored the Vikings 124-54 in the last three meetings. The last win for the Vikings in the series on this field, 17-14 in 2012.
Man, Quan Stokes, Will Reichert, Griffin Rigsby, that offensive line has done well.
Michael Barrett on the carry, picks up four on the play. And as we mentioned earlier, this has been a very streaky series dating back to its beginnings in 1978. Lowndes won 9 of the first 11. Then Colquitt County behind head coach Jim Hughes won 9 straight. Then Lowndes won 14 out of 15. And then the sheriff arrived in Moultrie named Rush Probst. And it's been the Packers series over the last 5 years, as we have a penalty here against the Vikings.
All right, John Nelson, we got our first false start. One of the big things that we talked about from Lowndes, they didn't get rattled, they didn't get penalties.
Now we just have to keep an eye on the holding calls.
Yep.
See if that happens next, trying to get caught up in the moment.
So now second down and 11. Michael Barrett, 8 carries, 50 yards thus far, and Barrett's going to hand the ball off. J.D. Lee getting his first carry of the ball game, and Lee picks up just a couple of yards on the play.
Well, nice job by the Colquitt front
forming a wall. Everybody had their gaps. We talked about you got to be real disciplined going against this Lowndes offense, and that time they did a great job playing their positions.
I think one of the untold stories of this Packers team this year has been their defense. They have held three of their last five opponents to two touchdowns or less. Barrett steps up, has time, throws, and off the hands of Tyson Harris at the 35-yard line. You got to figure it's going to be very difficult for Lowndes to win this game tonight without their top wide receiver, Xavier Jenkins, the ESPN three-star who originally committed to Georgia, decommitted, still has offers from the Bulldogs, Louisville, yep, and Mississippi State. But he is injured tonight, out with a knee injury. They're hoping to get him back to the playoffs.
Almost got blocked there.
Punt by Tyson Shaw is going to be fair caught at the 48-yard line by Torrey Ponder. And that's where the Packers go back on offense with 41 seconds to play in the half. And great field position as we throw it down to John Nelson, who's going to kick it.
Yeah, well, there you go. Let's kick it and show you Swamp War, some single A. If Clinch County wins tonight, they're one of the 21 teams that could get you a region championship right now. Clinch and Charlton, you see the score. It was 8-0. Charlton with a score. It's now 8-3 in the second quarter. Charlton right now, 38th in the power rankings, could be the first time in Rich McWhorter's 27 years that if they don't make it to the playoffs, that would be a first for Charlton County. That makes it 14-3. PAT coming for Clinch County, guys.
Well, this is a big defensive series for the Vikings. They got to come up with a stop. Sharonsky Sloan with the catch and run. They have a hard time getting him on the ground. And finally, the defensive tackle, Devon Holmes, way downfield, tackles Sharonsky Sloan. But that's a big pickup for the Packers. The Packers score here. The Vikings are in deep early trouble.
Well, good job by the senior, 5'10", 150 pounds. Sharonsky Sloan gets his head around, catches the ball, and makes some yards after the catch.
18-yard pickup. Hand off into the middle of the field. Edwards picks up four on the play.
He was dancing, had good feet then, kind of tiptoeing and dancing a little back and forth. Picks up, what, 4 yards, 5 yards?
Yep, second down and six, and that is the end of the first quarter.
Well, you know, Lowndes going to have to bow their necks. And that's a South Georgia turn there now. If your backup gets the ball, you got to bow your necks. We'll see how they do here going into the second quarter.
Well, the game started well for the Vikings as they drove 80 yards on their first possession, but that was short-lived as J.J. Peterson took it back 98 yards. Picked by Schamberger. Two turnovers for the Packers have led to two Packers touchdowns, and Colquitt County has a 21-7 lead after one.
The test that we're finding to be a gold standard for determining how affected someone is by a concussion is their balance. So the new machine that we bought is called the Proprio 5000. It gives us baseline data on someone's balance. There's a 2-minute test that we do, and it gives them an objective score on that balance test. We want to make sure that they're, you know, 95% plus before they get back to the game.
At the heart of our community are the businesses that don't skip a beat. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives stand behind local commerce, whether keeping farms running or shining a light on new ventures. We bring business, large and small, to our communities. Creating jobs, driving development, supporting dreams. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Nothing prepares you better for a great career than the Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG colleges produce graduates with the knowledge and training today's top employers are looking for. With campuses across Georgia, state-of-the-art facilities, and outstanding instructors with real-world experience, it's the kind of affordable college education that will fast-track you into a rewarding career. We're building a better future for you. Contact the TCSG college in your area today or go to tcsg.edu.
Stay connected to your team like never before with the GPB Sports Football app. Get the latest news. Watch featured games live wherever you are.
Finds a hole. Look at that. Look at that.
Find relevant info on schools and take interactive 3D tours of stadiums around the state. Tweet game highlights from the stands and get up-to-the-minute scores all Friday night. The gridiron has gone digital. Download the free GPB Sports Football app from the iTunes App Store now.
Rush Probst going for his 268th all-time win here tonight. He had 176 of them coming in the state of Alabama. And, of course, there at famed Hoover High School, that right now losing to Grayson 6-0.
Okay.
In an interstate battle between Grayson and Hoover. And Grayson is a team that this Colquitt County team could end up facing in the quarterfinals of the state playoffs this year if the brackets play out with the favorites winning.
Well, Russ Probst, I mean, one of the all-time great high school coaches, and it's really good talking ball with him. When you listen to him, you realize how much ball and how much he really knows. Really a credit to high school football here in Georgia.
Meantime, the Vikings are in deep trouble here. Handoff goes to Leggett, and Leggett got tackled at the 20-yard line, and the flag is down. I believe we will have a face mask as Ty Leggett just gashed him for 10 yards.
Ty Leggett looked like he had a rocket connected to his feet. He was rolling outside zone play by Colquitt. Jay Saunders options off the defensive end, decides to give it to him. And watch this burst. He just sizzles. Gets 10 yards really, really fast.
And there was the face masking penalty right there on Tymir Moore. So that will... Let's see where they're going to spot this. After the mark off, I believe it will be the 10-yard line. 10-yard line, and that is where the Packers have it, first and goal to go. Vikings are getting ready to fall behind by 3 touchdowns in the first 13 minutes of this game.
And this Lowndes team has been a second-half team, but you don't want to get behind here on the road with a big number.
Dajon Edwards not going anywhere. Edwards got stopped in his tracks. Tyson Shaw was the first guy to hit him.
Nice job by Lowndes. The Vikings swarming to the ball. Nice job competing. I'm counting all the guys, and I'm watching their body language. Particularly when you're on the road, I like the way they're running to the ball. The Vikings are still fighting. They're bowing their necks, Matt. They're bowing their necks.
Vikings defense with 2 shutouts this season against Palm Beach, Florida, Bayside, and Shiloh. But they've also surrendered at least 34 points in 4 games this season, including their loss to Valdosta. Saunders with time throws to the end zone and just beyond the outstretched hands of Sharansky Sloan. Lowndes began the season with a demoralizing loss to their crosstown rivals Valdosta in the Wintersville Classic, but they have rattled off 8 straight victories since. They have not scored less than 35 points in any game, and only 2 of the games have been decided by less than 21 points. This is the first third down for Randy McPherson's team tonight. Third down on defense, that is, and it's caught for a touchdown by Torrey Ponder, and it's 27-7.
Nice job by Jay Saunders sitting back in the pocket and finding the open receiver. But again, you can throw, you can catch, but without them big guys on that offensive line, none of this is possible. Best blocking I've seen so far in the first half, protection-wise, from an offense this year here at Colquitt County.
28-7. 28 unanswered points by the Packers as we take a look at our TCSG touchdown replay.
Great job again by the front. Lowndes ends up sending pressure. They bring a 5th blitzer. The offensive line of Colquitt does an excellent job. I got to give them credit. Ian Brinson, Quan Stokes, Will Reichard, Griffin Rigsby, Tyler Howard. Listen, they are protecting. I'm telling you, You would have thought the president of America, the United States, was in the pocket there protecting. I'm telling you, the best offensive protection I've seen all year in the state of Georgia on GPB as we've been doing these games. Right now, they are the MVPs of this game.
Fourth touchdown catch of the season for Torrey Ponder as we send it down to John Nelson.
All right, so I guess, Chuck, you call him the Secret Service. That's what you're going to call the Colquitt offensive line. It's time to kick it and show you some 7A from Cobb County. Marietta fumbled the football. McEachern turned it into a 33-yard field goal to make it 10-0. And you know that left hand, Bailey Hockman, touchdown pass. 17-0 McEachern leading Marietta. Marietta's got a very good young team. McEachern right now with the pedal down, 17-0 in the second back upstairs.
Thank you, Nelly. Matt Stewart and Chuck Smith up here and our GPB crew with you in South Georgia tonight.
11,000 here, a little more. And the fire marshal shut it down.
Maligon with the kickoff. It'll be non-returnable. We'll have to talk to him about that, but you're right. I'm pretty sure they had the fire marshal at the gate counting people right up to kickoff. They've got as many people in here and probably a little bit more than that as they could possibly hold. I'm pretty sure we've got more people than seats in this stadium tonight. Great atmosphere, and the Packers trying to win their third straight region championship have jumped out to a 28-7 lead following their six-play, 52-yard drive. And now the Vikings got to do a couple of things. Number one, they got to hold the ball for a while.
Exactly.
And number two, they got to get points out of it.
You're exactly right. Jeff Hammond has to figure it out. The offensive coordinator for Lowndes, they got to get back to what they do best, run the ball.
Handoff, Tisdale, only a couple of yards on that play. Schamberger making the tackle.
Right now you got Colquitt, they're loading up the box. 7-8 defenders because they're expecting a run. But when they do pass, when Lowndes passes, Colquitt is just dropping back in the zone. They're dropping seven back, rushing four.
Second down and seven from the 23. Barrett to the air. That's caught for a first down by Tyson Harris. And then a big hit by Tyrese Barge, but Harris holds on for the first down.
Well, good job by Harris on the slant route, getting his hands up under the ball. You're always coached to watch the ball all the way till you tuck it away. Nice job by Michael Barrett getting the ball out of his hands, making a nice throwing catch. They needed that. The Vikes needed that.
Randy McPherson says that Michael Barrett, they knew he would be a good quarterback, but he has exceeded even his expectations. Handoff goes to Tisdale, and a big hole for Tisdale as Dawson finally gets him on the ground, but not until he crosses the 50 and down to the 45.
Excellent job. Nice run. Outside zone play by Tisdale. He takes it and gets downfield. What I like about him, not a lot of shaking and baking. One cut and go. That's what you want in your running backs. Nice run by Tisdale.
Tisdale now 74 yards rushing.
Got a little Nick Chubb in him, like you said earlier.
So first and 10, ball is at the 45-yard line. Now Tisdale sprints outside. And a timeout has been called by Lowndes.
Well, I had to believe in on that last play. They were going to call a quarterback power, one back power. Take the ball and take a chance going in the middle. Because every time they've thrown the ball the last couple series, it's been an interception or a bad break, you know. So, but what do you see here again, Matt? They're running the ball. They're having success. But when they pull the ball up to pass, they've had some bad breaks happen for them.
Well, as we mentioned off the top, Lowndes is shooting for their first region title since 2010. They've won five state championships in their history, most recently 2007. And as you can see, between 2004 and 2007, they won 3 out of 4 years. Quarterfinals are better, 10 of the last 20 years. The record since 1996, 193-46, 11 region titles. And they had 4 coaches their first 8 years, but only 4 coaches the last 40. And for the last 15 years, it has been that man right there, Randy McPherson.
Well, Randy McPherson, great coach, understands how to get the most out of your players, has brought this program to places where, you know, a lot of people in that town thought they'd never be, particularly with that bully across town, Valdosta, winning all those championships.
No doubt, Randy McPherson helped them flip the script. Barrett going up top and throwing and nearly intercepted at the 25-yard line. Caleb Dawson breaking on the ball, nearly got the pick. And now it's going to be second down.
Well, I wasn't a math major, but I can count a little bit.
four wide receivers going out, six defensive backs sitting back there in the zone waiting for the ball to come their way. Michael Barrett has to be very careful. I like to see him drop back in the pass and send those four deep and sometimes scramble, take off and run with it.
Handoff goes to Tisdale, and Nelson Lewis, who had the interception earlier in this ball game, made the tackle right there.
Nice tackle by Nelson Lewis, wrapping him up and taking him down, scraping to the ball. Colquitt defense is playing some good ball right now.
Yeah, Nelson came into the ball game with 38 tackles on the season, 7 for loss and 3 quarterback sacks. He's already picked up his second interception of the season in this game. He had one last week against Tiff. Third down, Vikes are 2 of 4 on their thirds. Blitz is coming off the edge. Barrett, quick drop, throws behind Tavon Kyle, and it's fourth down.
Tavon Kyle was wide open that time. Colquitt ended up sending pressure. They blitzed. Michael Barrett got a little rattled then, tried to get the ball out there too quick. The route wasn't developed yet, and that's why the receiver wasn't ready. Didn't get his head back, turned around towards the quarterback. And as you can see here, the blitz comes and it doesn't get here. He rushes. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That time, Colquitt brought a 7-man pressure, which they haven't done the entire game. Rattled Michael Barrett.
Fair catch is made at the 13-yard line. And that's where the Packers will go back on offense, and they already have a 3-touchdown lead.
Okay, Matt, let me take you in the mind if I'm a Colquitt Packer.
Yep.
I'm trying to put that final stamp on this first half, saying it is our show.
Yep.
You guys are trying to measure up to us. And if you're right now, if you're Lowndes, if you're the Vikings, you got to bow your neck.
Yep.
You can't give up another touchdown. Remember this, and me and Nelson talked about this earlier in the game, that Lowndes, they're a second half team. But I don't know if they're a 21-point down in Moultrie, Georgia kind of comeback
team,
Nelly.
You're right.
What do you think about that, Nelly?
Right there with you, partner. Always hide behind the larger lineman.
Keeper by Saunders. Jay Saunders off to the races. And Brent Carter finally runs him down at the 35. Talk about element of surprise.
I thought he was a big-time passer. I didn't know he had them wheels, Matt. Nice job by Jay Saunders. He options off the defensive end. Look, the defensive end gets blocked and stays outside. Excellent blocking. I didn't see who the blocker was, but Saunders made a great read off the defensive end. The defensive end got blocked. Excellent job.
37-yard run by Saunders. To the air he goes and through the hands of Ponder.
Threw behind him.
Man, look here. That was a nice run.
You know, Saunders had big shoes to fill when he took over as a starting quarterback this year. Chase Parrish, who was undefeated as the Packers quarterback his last two seasons, now at the Naval Academy.
This offense has my head spinning. So many different formations.
Ball fumbled, and Leggett
got it.
Did not get on top of it. Leggett tried to fall on top of it and didn't, and Abi David, the nose guard, was there to hop on it.
Well, that's what you need if you're Lowndes. You needed something to stop the bleeding. Ball goes to the ground. It was just a miscommunication. Simple handoff. Oh, that time looks like Jay Saunders had the ball a little high. You try to put the ball to the belly, about where that belly button is. Looks like Jay had a little high miscommunication, a little bumbling in the backfield. Lowndes has an opportunity to kind of get this momentum going their way a little bit going into halftime.
And I agree with you, Chuck. That fumble was not Leggett's fault, but it is his fourth fumble of the season.
That's a good point there.
It was a high handoff.
Good point. You're right. And
but Leggett
fumbled. The eye in the sky don't lie.
Yep. First and 10 now for the Vikings at the 40. Let's see if they can cash in with the turnover. Barrett stands in the pressure, dumps it deep, got a man, and Kyle could not hold on to it. And J.J. Peterson reminding him of how wide open he was when he dropped it.
Well, Kyle's going to have a dream about this one later on. But, again, you got to watch the ball. Good job by Michael Barrett buying time when everything is crumbling around him. Gets the ball off. Kyle has to make this catch. If you're going to win a region championship in Moultrie, Georgia, you have to make those kind of plays. Mm.
Randy McPherson thought they had a big gainer right there, if not a touchdown. Second down and 10.
Well, Barrett did a great job. Protection wasn't there.
Gonna keep it, and Barrett wrestled to the ground by Allen Key.
Allen Key been very active. Good job getting his hands, getting off the block. Good job using his hands and snatching off the block. That's what defensive coaches like. You want a guy that's sudden. Snatches off the block, gets there, does a good job getting Michael Barrett on the ground.
Big shoes for Allen Key to fill this year as he took over at the Mike linebacker for Bull Barge, who's now...
Love me some Bull Barge.
He's now
Bull Barge.
Playing at South Alabama.
That was my guy last year, Bull Barge. That boy was thicker than a snicker. He had that fight in him, too.
His cousin Tyrese plays safety for the Packers this year. That was Willie DeBruce who jumped off sides. And so now it's going to be third down and two.
Well, as a defensive line coach, nothing worse than that. That changes the dynamics here of what Lowndes has. Before, you're not going to run third and eight, but now it gives them another option. They can run it here or they can pass it. That's might be even two down territory right here for me.
That's Bull's cousin, number one, Tyrese Barge. Now third down and short. Barrett will run for the first down.
Now, from a football strategy standpoint, think about this. Third and eight's a lot different than third and two.
Yeah.
That option wasn't there on third and eight. You saw the difference of what that penalty did for Lowndes. Man, I used to be real hot when my D lineman jumped off sides when I was coaching at Tennessee. They didn't want to come to that side.
No, sir.
My eyes get the red.
Handoff goes to Tisdale. Cutback for Tisdale down to the 39-yard line as Tisdale picks up a solid eight on the play.
Man, let me give some credit right now to Michael Barrett. Did you see how long he held the ball on that zone read? I mean, he held it in the belly of the running back for at least 2 or 3 seconds. Nice work there. Nice work.
137 yards of rushing for Lowndes in this first half. And we're not halfway through the second quarter, but they're down 3 touchdowns. Mistakes have killed them. Harris goes in motion. Double move, and Kyle gets another chance at it. Can't run under it.
Well-designed play. Fake the inside zone. Pump it. Man, Kyle was there, just overthrew it again. Colquitt is not having a lot of great pressure from the D-line, but they're having just enough. What's happening is Michael Barrett's rushing it. I mean, sometimes when you get hit a few times and you're a runner, you don't get all your wits back under your belt. You know what I mean? And you don't know where guys are coming from. Just he's got to be calm, make better throws. He's going to need to make those plays later on in the game.
Well, Barrett, who's completed over 66% of his passes this season, only 3 of 11 here tonight, and runs into a stone wall. They're going to blow it dead back at the 37-yard line, although Barrett ended up all the way up at the 47.
Okay, we got a little getting a little frisky out there. These are rivals. They don't like each other very much. They're not inviting each other to Thanksgiving very often, brother. Well, look, just like any boxer now, my good friend Evander Holyfield, I tell you this. If you get hit enough, eventually everybody gets affected. Michael Barrett is the entire offense pretty much running the ball. He's throwing it. He's running it. So some of these other players have to take some of the pressure off of him. But we talked about the pregame and the Komatsu forklift keys to the game. He's got to be that guy.
Well, you can see the crowd for Lowndes highly agitated that they had blown the play dead at the 37 after Barrett on second and third effort had gotten the ball up to the 47. So
that's that little extra the defensive guys do to kind of just rough you up a little bit.
So now it's going to be third down.
Yeah. Barrett's, I mean, giving a workmanlike effort right now. But again, those hits start taking a toll on you. You know, this Colquitt defense has been getting after it today.
So let's see. They're going to measure here at the 37 to see if he picked up the first down.
All right, Eagle Eye down here on the floor says it's about 3 inches short. I think the nose of the football has to get to the 37 paint.
I think he got it, Nelly. From up here, looks like he got it. You got your glasses on, old man?
Hold it there, cowboy.
Nelly was 1 for 2 last week.
Yeah, I saw the second one from a 45-degree angle. I'll blame that.
All right,
bad,
whatever.
Nelly,
excuses.
I got 3 inches short.
You're wrong.
Oh, that's a nose of the foot.
Told you. You see how big my eyes are? Well, I could probably see Atlanta from here with these. they needed that, though.
I can tell you what, I can see it real good when we get the camera right down there by the football.
No. Well, yeah, that's Wes Nichols. He's working hard.
I like these monitors up here, though. You don't have to use your binoculars.
Chuck Smith, monitor man.
That's me.
Hashtag Dr. Rush, hashtag monitor man.
Well, there you go. The Vikings pick up the first down. First and 10, ball at the 37-yard line.
Barrett is the catalyst to make this offense go for Lowndes.
He's got 60 yards rushing on 11 carries. His passing, though, is what he has lacked in tonight. Only 3 of 11 for 55 yards. Handoff goes to J.D. Lee. Lee cuts inside and down to the 21-yard line. Schamberger tackles, but that's a first down carry for J.D. Lee.
There you go. That's a way to take some of the pressure off your quarterback. J.D. Lee takes it, gets downhill, outside zone play, outside the tackle. Nice job. Again, I can't say enough about Michael Barrett having great vision and knowing when to give the ball to the running back or keep it.
Impressed by this Vikings ground game. See if they make it into points, however. Tisdale got run down from behind by Tyrese Barge. How about Barge? If we can see that replay, he came off the edge from the blitz and ran all the way through the backfield and ran down his man.
That could have been six.
Here he comes. He's going to tackle Barrett. Barrett doesn't have it. I'll just get that guy.
Man, great effort. Great effort. He's going to get a grading point. That you get grading points for great plays. He's going to get one of those from Coach Probst this week. That's an effort. Yep. Instead of getting 2 points, you get them for tackling. You get two for tackling. Maybe you get one for extra effort.
He came nice into the job. Ball game, leading tackler on this team with 64 stops on the year. He's committed to Troy. First down, zone read. Barrett keeps it. Nice shifty move. Runs for the pylon and gets there.
Man, he is a magician with that ball. It's hard to tell exactly what he's doing. I understand the concepts, Matt, of what they're doing. Inside zone, outside zone, optioning off the tight end. That time, the defensive end ended up crashing down. Excellent job by Michael Barrett, having his eyes on his work, knowing where he's supposed to be and getting downfield. And then when he gets in the secondary, welcome to the party, y'all.
Look at that cut right there, man. He had Allen Key falling on his face. PAT by Colton Broom is good, and it's 28-14, and Lowndes really needed that.
Ask me how big that was, Matt. Ask me how big that was.
How big was it?
Huge. Mega.
It was huge.
Stone Mountain big.
Barrett's 17-yard touchdown run to cut the Packers' lead in half.
National Beef is proud to support the South Georgia Gridiron Classic, serving over 1 million pounds of beef products weekly to tens of thousands of families throughout the region. National Beef is a proud member of the Moultrie and Colquitt County community. Whether you plan to attend a 2-year college, 4-year university, or go straight into the world of work, the Georgia Career, Technical, and Agricultural Education programs teach students essential career skills through real-world experiences and on-the-job training.
Across 91 counties, Georgia's cotton industry employs over 15,000 people, with more than 3,000 Georgia farmers that bring cotton into our everyday lives. When life turns up the heat and the pressure makes you sweat, there's one sure way to cool down. For those glory moments on and off the court, cotton is with you for the win. Cotton, the natural choice for Georgia.
Welcome back to the Hog Pen. 4:49 to go for the first half, 28-14, with the Mayflower Moving Company putting points on the board. So, Chuck Smith,
yep.
What time is it?
It's time to kick it!
And there's a reason we're kicking it to this particular game, is because there are some colors that Chuck is familiar with. 7:14 to go. Second, Walnut Grove completes a 25-yard touchdown pass. So it is 14-7 at that point. Now you see where it's turned. Clark Central now 21-14 on Walnut Grove in the second quarter. So, Chuck Smith is a happy man second quarter with what Coach Perno has been putting on the board back upstairs.
I'm excited about what Coach Perno's doing, but hey, Nell, I need you to get an update on North Gwinnett. The Bulldogs, Young Chuck Smith has been moved up to varsity, man. So North Gwinnett is on the menu tonight.
Right, we'll work on that one. Here's another one for you. South Gwinnett leads Archer 2-0.
2-0.
Two-run homer by the Comets to put them on the board early on. And Archer could make the playoffs at 4-6.
Yep. Well, I mean, we know nobody. I mean, we talked about Colquitt County's incredible difficult schedule, but nobody played a more difficult schedule than Archer did. In non-region, and then, of course, when they got into their region and had to play Grayson, too.
Yeah, and that's so you've got a lot of difficult schedules this year and next year. The schedule makers had fun. The teams playing them, not so much.
Nope. Yeah, Archer ended up playing all five teams ranked in the current GPB 7A top 10, all of the top five teams, and Colquitt playing Lowndes tonight means they played three of the top six.
Well, Colquitt is playoff ready. They play teams, and that's what you get. Anytime you play a tough schedule, it builds character and it builds resilience. And when you see what this team has done, they have an opportunity to do some big things in the playoffs.
Well, if you're Colton Broom, you don't want to kick it to that guy again. And Willie DeBruce has it go off his hands, and then J.J. Peterson ends up picking it up. And Peterson this time is going to get gang tackled at the 11-yard line.
But that was that thigh out. That was a thigh out hit.
They were determined not to let him get his hands on the ball, but he still did.
Limping a little bit coming off the field.
Well, I guess so. He had seven guys jump on top of him at one time.
He'll learn that plays like that, the young man, you just get down. There was nothing you were going to gain on that. You had 11 guys that already had broken through the wall, and they were basically coming down to hit you.
Well, here comes Jay Saunders. What a night he's had so far. 7 of 9,
dangerous.
116, 2 touchdown passes, and he's also run the ball 3 times for 40 yards and a touchdown.
Jay Saunders has been dangerous tonight.
Back to the air he goes, swings it out here, complete. Dancing around, and nothing's going to happen. They're going to lose yards on that play on the pass completion to Ty Powell. They actually lost a couple of yards.
Swing pass, Ty Powell. Good job by Lowndes. Defense swarming to the ball. You want to get 11 hats on the ball. That's what they're doing right now. Good stuff, Bubba Walker. Sorry, not Bubba Walker. David Shores got his guy swarming.
Second down and 12. Again, nothing happening. That's consecutive stonewalls by the Vikings on the handoff to Dajon Edwards.
Looks like the Vikings have eaten their spinach a little bit on the D-line. Manning up right now, doing a good job swarming. Colquitt has to try to find an answer. These boys are so dangerous, though.
Packers 1-for-1 on their third down. Saunders running and throwing and caught at the 20-yard line for a first down by Torrey Ponder. Good job by Saunders to keep the play alive long enough to get it to an open man.
Well, excellent job by Saunders, but again, you get a three-man rush from Lowndes. It's going to give Jay Saunders a lot of time. The bottom line is, in my opinion, when you rush three and you can't get no pressure, when you got a quarterback that's smart like this, he's going to find some hole there and make a great play like that.
Saunders keeps it again. And Saunders, another big run. Waits for his blockers to get downfield. Ponder throws a block and finally brought down by Tyson Shaw way downfield. Another huge run for Jay Saunders.
I said a second ago, your boy is bad. He is dangerous. Jay Saunders right now, I'm telling you. I mean, he is completely in control of this game right now. He's making plays with his arm. He's making plays with his legs. I mean, he's having a heck of a game right now, but I ain't surprised. He's a baller.
42-yard pickup for Jay Saunders. Packers have it at the Vikings 37. That's Singletary in motion. Let's see if they throw his direction. Nope, they go in the middle of the field, and it's caught by Schenker. Schenker down to the 20-yard line, and a first down grab. Second catch of the night for John Schenker.
Well, good job by Schenker getting vertical, sitting down. It was just basically a go route. Jay Saunders does a good job of finding the seam. Again, Saunders having a great day. Good job by his tight end.
Man, Schenker is a good-looking tight end, too, at 6'4", 229. First and 10 from the 20. Ty Leggett on the carry. Leggett tackled by the linebacker, Jeffrey Davis.
It's tough here. You got a quarterback that's throwing it. Then you got guys that are running it. Right now, Lowndes County is off balance. Defensive coordinator David Shores has got to figure it out. You got to take away something. You can't just give up runs and passes. Commit eight to the box, at least stop that. You got to get after the quarterback here, Jay Saunders, a little better than you've done.
Second down and three, ball at the 13-yard line. Packers trying to score again. Edwards gets the handoff. Massive block in the middle of the line and a first down carry for Edwards inside the five. Watch this massive block on the left side of the line right here. Bam! Just took out Jeffrey Davis. I think that was Tyler Howard, number 65. I think it was Howard that took out Jeffrey Davis.
This offensive line in Brinson, number 70, Quan Stokes, 77. They have been doing an excellent job on pass protection, and they are road grading Lowndes' defense right now in this drive.
And a timeout has been called as the Packers have it first and goal to go inside the 5-yard line. And Randy McPherson's team that has lost three in a row in this rivalry in danger of going back down by three touchdowns again before halftime. I was really impressed by the block here. They just took out Jeffrey Davis. Davis 10 is their top tackler on the team. Yeah, and that was Tyler Howard.
Tyler Howard, Quan Stokes. And that's what you love. I mean, they're wide bodies, man. I mean, you love those guys with their hips, when they get next to each other, it's like a bunch of hippos. I'm telling you, man, they roll, and when they come after you, there's nothing you can do.
I'm sure they would appreciate that analogy.
But what's the most dangerous animal in the world? Hippos. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
But now you do. Do your research.
If they sit on you, I know that's the end of you.
Call me about the answer this week sometime.
Okay. All right, I'll do that.
Great job, though, right now. This offensive line is in total control. They're doing a great job protecting Jay Saunders. They're also doing a great job running the ball. What else can you ask for from a group of big boys?
First and goal to go from the 4. Jay Saunders, 10 of 12 passing, 148, couple of touchdowns, 4 of 82 rushing, and a touchdown. Tyson Shaw making the tackle on the run right into the teeth of that defense right there. Nothing doing on that carry, and it's going to be second down. Dejon Edwards.
If I'm thinking like David Shores, we cannot give up a touchdown. Got to make a commitment to stop the run. No one runs on you on the goal line. That's what your mentality has to be. If you're going to get something, trick us with a pass.
Edwards comes out of the game. Leggett comes in. Edwards, 6 carries, 31 yards tonight. Leggett, 2 carries for 19. Oh, wow. What a move by Saunders, who's having himself a night. Faked out the defender and then danced into the end zone. Faked the pitch and took it in, 34-14.
Well, great design by offensive coordinator Jeff Hammond. Spreads out, puts 4 wides, fakes the inside zone. Jay Saunders having a magnificent night. Going for 2 here.
No, they're just going to kick it. Just giving them something to think about.
Man, they got me. Look, Jeff Hammond got so many formations, got my head spinning.
Fitzgerald, PAT, 35-14. Jay Saunders scores his second touchdown of the night on our TCSG touchdown replay. Watch the fake.
Look, Cap just goes in there. Uh-huh. Welcome to my house. Jay Saunders having a heck of a game here today. Total control of the offense. Just driving that car every time into that end zone. Colquitt.
Wow.
Man, hard to stop. 35 right now going into halftime.
And Rush Probst told us, look, you know, we asked him, so what clicked on this 5-game winning streak you're on right now? And he said it was nothing really magical other than we just weren't playing nationally ranked teams every week. You know, they opened against Mill Creek, number 1 ranked team in Georgia. They played American Heritage out of Plantation, Florida. They missed 3 chip shot field goals in that game, probably should have won it. Had a lead on Tucker going to the fourth quarter. Rush Probst says that's the first game we've lost in the fourth quarter since I've been here. And then Roswell in the rematch of the state championship game, Hornets got them back.
But everyone here, everybody in the Colquitt community in this program knew they were young. They were young. But coming out of it, it built camaraderie, it built resilience. And when you measure up against those other teams, it wasn't like outside of Tucker they were getting destroyed, you know?
Malagon kicks it into the end zone, so the Vikings will have it at the 20-yard line. And then, you know, as we were looking at the schedule, they played those four games. It's not like the schedule got really that much easier.
Right.
They blew out a good Brookwood team. They blew out a Valdosta team that's ranked number one in 6A right now. So,
and that Brookwood team's going to be in the playoffs.
Oh, yeah. That Brookwood team is playing Norcross tonight for the Region 7 championship.
Yep. Norcross, another team that's going to have a say in who wins the championship in 7A. Roswell, they're balling. Mill Creek, well coached.
So Vikings back on offense at the 20-yard line. They have no timeouts remaining, so it'll be interesting to see whether they just try to run the clock out here and end the half. Not been a good half for them. It started well, and they've run the ball well, but two critical turnovers, both of which were cashed in for touchdowns by Colquitt County. Plus, you throw in the 98-yard kickoff return touchdown by J.J. Peterson. That's the difference in the ball game right now.
Last series, you get a touchdown by Michael Barrett. Colquitt comes back and puts seven on the board to match him.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you obviously do the math. You can't get into a match for match now. You got to come up with some stops.
Got to score big
in the second half. Yep. Right. So first and 10 for the Vikings, ball at the 20. And handoff goes to Tisdale. Ooh, Brian Merritt slammed him, body slammed him at the line of scrimmage.
Nice job by Brian Merritt. Nice tackle. Nice job getting off on the block.
Merritt's just a sophomore. He's the leading tackler on the defensive line. 54 stops on the season coming into tonight with 8 tackles for loss.
Well, coach said he's been stepping up, has a bright future. As you can look at him here, he's got great size. He's going to be a good one here for the Packers.
And guess who called the timeout? Rush Probst called the timeout because he wants to get the ball back again before halftime.
Yep.
All right, time to kick it, guys, and we're going to show you Mazen Alexander. 21 games, we said, going into tonight could have region implications for champions, and here's one of them brought to you by our friends in the middle of the screen. Right now it's 7-7. It was 7-7 was the first indication that we had, but apparently Mays has missed that point after. So heading to the second quarter, Mazen Alexander in a game that will decide the 1 and the 2, more than likely, in that region, 7-6. Alexander with the lead second quarter. Other news, Northside and Houston County. Houston County leads 31-28 at the half. So that's good news in game 9. If you're a Hoco Loco right now, you got to win this one. You got to win against Valdosta next week. Good news after 24 minutes, guys.
Thank you, Nelly. Second down. Barrett going to keep it. Runs into his own man, then surges forward and picks up the first down and more. And Tyrese Barge has a hard time getting him on the ground, but finally does at the 30-yard line, 35-yard line. That'll move the sticks. And let's see. Likely, I'm guessing, did they call him? Colquitt's not going to call another timeout after they picked up the first down.
I don't know. Looks like here, Lowndes, are they going to try to give Barrett another run, maybe take a shot downfield?
If you can get another run like that, maybe you do take a shot if you can get the ball close to midfield.
Communicating with the sideline, maybe they are going to take a shot.
Down to 15 seconds. Tisdale. And Tisdale up to the 50-yard line, and Tisdale finally steps out of bounds with 5 seconds on the clock. That stops the clock, 45-yard line. I'd wind up and throw the ball to the end zone.
Well, I agree with you here on that one. Now I take a shot.
Yeah, just send everybody deep and throw it as high and far as you can.
I like number 6, Travis Tisdale, sophomore, 5'11", 180. He's got some juice.
They line up 3 here on the near side. Here comes the Hail Mary. Barrett steps up, fires as deep as he can go, and it's going to be intercepted or broken up. Did they rule interception or not? Yep, that's an interception. Or was it?
That's hard to see.
Number 7 for Lowndes ended up with the ball. That's Miko Washington. So I don't think it was interception. That's the end of the half. And Colquitt County will take a 35-14 lead. It was not caught by either team. And so 35-14, Colquitt County heads to the locker room with a three-touchdown lead.
You think that man Rush Probst is satisfied?
No.
His face doesn't change whether it's a touchdown or a fumble. That's the old ball coach. I like it.
Well, speaking of Rush, he's standing by with John Nelson.
All right, it was a bit of a rhetorical question from Chuck Smith. Is Rush happy with the first half? He laughed and said no. Your answer to the rhetorical?
No. No, I mean, yeah. I mean, you got to be pleased that we've scored. I mean, obviously, you know, I'm displeased with the fumble that we had right there that gave him the 14. You know, we could have been up 35-7. Same situation. We could have got it back and may have put it away, but we didn't. And, you know, now we're up 21, but really, the way these things go, you better play it like 0-0.
All right, thanks for your time. Go get him. I think he's going to be working on a lot more stuff, Chuck, so we'll get back to Rush's ideas in a bit. The halftime show officially starts right now.
Rush is happy, but not completely happy.
No, I love it. I love the mentality of being 0-0 at the half.
Absolutely. All right, coming up on our Football Fridays in Georgia halftime show, we will hear from the Lowndes marching band. Plus, we'll have scores from all over the state of Georgia.
Plus, we'll inform you what's going on with social media. John Nelson goes to a place he's very familiar with. We'll see him in the principal's office. And I'll talk to some very proud parents from some big players on the field. That and more coming up in the GPB halftime show. We'll see you in a few.
This moment, getting here took 3 years of sleepless nights and postponed vacations. Your dad said, play it safe. Your husband kept the faith. But franchising is why you partnered with Regions in the first place. We share your vision for moving forward. And at moments like this,
hi, Steve.
That makes all the difference. Is your business at a turning point? Regions.
Agricultural, food, and environmental industries are the biggest economic driver in Georgia, and they impact our life every day. That's why the University of Georgia's College of Agricultural and Environmental Sciences is so important to our future. Small class sizes encourage hands-on learning from world-renowned faculty, alongside cutting-edge research at campuses in Athens, Griffin, and Tifton. CAES gives students real-world experiences and teaches applied skills for high, in-demand jobs.
At 60 miles per hour, you go the length of a football field in 5 seconds. But would you do it blindfolded? When you text and drive, that's what happens. Heads up, Georgia. Texting and driving is against the law.
The greatest predator since the dinosaur, and one may be living in your home. Cats are a diverse family of hunters, but they share one genetic blueprint that has served them well. From ancient rainforests to the African savanna, they've conquered the globe. This is the story of cats, an 11 million year evolutionary journey into our homes.
Part of GPB's Why Wednesday, this Wednesday at 8.
We are live at a jam-packed Tom White Field. We are live at MacTharp Stadium. We are live from Moultrie, Georgia, with the two-time defending state champion Colquitt County Packers lead Lowndes 35-14 at the half. The Lowndes marching high school band is getting ready to take the field. But first, we check in with Jackie, who's got the latest about what fans are buzzing about on the World Wide Web.
Thank you, Mark. Let's get to a few tweets. Don't forget that on Twitter, you can cast your vote in our poll that we have. And so far, Colquitt County is totally owning the poll right now. 71% think that they are going to win this ball game. So, Lowndes, we want to hear from you guys. Make sure you're showing your spirit. Find us on Twitter. Our furthest viewer so far, Clarksville, Tennessee. Mark Roberts watching through the GPB Sports app, which is completely free. download it in the App Store and stay up to date. Then we have Scott chiming in, showing us some love, saying he loves when we come to town. So do we. Thank you for having us here in Moultrie. Then we have Jayla chiming in. Packers will win tonight, showing her support. Then we had Abby chiming in the spirit of Halloween. We had this photo a few weeks ago, and we just had to bring it back up with Halloween coming up here in a few days. And this is a kid from Mill Creek who dressed up as Coach Probst for Spirit Week. As you can see there, the little headbutt situation happening. And then we found this photo on Twitter that we wanted to share from a fan in the stands. A beautiful photo there at this game here in South Georgia. Darren chiming in saying, witnessing greatness for Lowndes High School, showing them some love. And this guy is just awesome, watching the World Series and the game here at the same time. That's what we love to see. So send us your photos here at GPB Sports. Find us on Facebook, Twitter, and also Snapchat. We'll have more coming up throughout the rest of the night.
And now let's check in with John Nelson. He's in the principal's office, I think. John?
That is correct. Time to be in the principal's office. And we're surrounded by Bridgemen, so we'll make this quick. What's going on at Lowndes these days? Good to see you, by the way.
Good to see you as well. What a great night for football, right? Well, lots of things going on. Our Bridgemen, who you're just about to hear, just brought home first in class at one of their recent competitions. Our FFA just got back from nationals, where 17 Lowndes High School students out of 20 brought home national titles. Our Air Force ROTC is winning as well in Bainbridge in their most recent competition. So lots of great things going on. And our girls softball team, our Lady Vikettes, are still in the Elite Eight up in Columbus. So lots going on at Lowndes High.
So she was at South Commons yesterday. She's here today. And now it's time to play the game that is sweeping the state of Georgia. Are you smarter? It's a question that neither of us have seen. So here we go. A recent poll of Halloween candy consumption state by state found that which confection is the top seller in Georgia? Is it A, Airheads, B, Pixie Sticks, or C, Candy Corn?
You know, I think Georgia is a classic state, so I'm going to go with the classic Candy Corn.
It's actually Pixie Sticks, apparently.
Oh,
so, okay, break out the Dust Buster. Right. It's Pixie Sticks, the candy-flavored powder that makes a giant mess, and yes, we know that for a fact. No, kids, Candy Corn does not count as a vegetable.
Oh.
Thanks for hanging out.
Sure, absolutely. Thank you for having me. You guys have a great night.
Good to see you. One round down. We'll be back in a bit with the other half.
I'm with Principal McCall. I like candy corn.
I thought it would have been candy corn.
Man, I'm with her. All right, a big part of the pageantry of high school football games is listening into the marching bands. We're going to listen into the Lowndes High School Marching Band right now, brought to you by Regions Bank. And remember, we're going to stream this entire performance live on our GPB Facebook page. We will archive it so you can watch it again whenever you want. So let's listen in to the Lowndes High School Marching Band, the Georgia Bridgemen. Great job by the Lowndes Marching Band, brought to you by Regions Bank. We're streaming it live on our Facebook page, so you can check that out. And they're playing the entire performance right now. And at the post-game show, we're going to have the 50th Regiment Marching Band from Colquitt County play their entire performance because they're getting ready for a big match or band
right.
off tomorrow.
They will play right when the game is over, so hopefully we'll be able to cut into them in the post-game show. That'd be great.
All right. Coming up next on our GPB Halftime Show, we'll hear from John Nelson, who takes a trip to a very special high school.
And also, I'll give you the 411 from some proud parents, and we'll have scores from around the entire state of Georgia, all the games that you want to know. It's all ahead when Football Fridays in Georgia Halftime Show continues right after this on GPB.
Support for GPB comes from Georgia Farm Bureau Mutual Insurance. From front porches to back roads, down the street or around the block, Georgia Farm Bureau is there with the protection families need, whether it's home, auto, or life insurance, or something more. Georgia Farm Bureau is dedicated to providing the right coverage to all the friends, families, and neighbors who make this state home. More at gfbinsurance.com. Georgia Farm Bureau, always the home team.
The tests that we're finding to be a gold standard for determining how affected someone is by a concussion is their balance. So the new machine that we bought is called the Proprio 5000. It gives us baseline data on someone's balance. There's a 2-minute test that we do, and it gives them an objective score on that balance test. We want to make sure that they're, you know, 95% plus before they get back to the game.
Whether you plan to attend a 2-year college, 4-year university, or go straight into the world of work, the Georgia Career, Technical, and Agricultural Education programs teach students essential career skills through real-world experiences and on-the-job training.
Today, companies in the aerospace, advanced manufacturing, and film industries need skilled workers, and the earning potential is high. Go Build Georgia can show you where the jobs are and what skills you need to get them. And the Technical College System of Georgia has fast, affordable training for these great paying careers. Build your blueprint for success at GoBuildGeorgia.com and look to the Technical College System of Georgia to put your plan into action.
Next time on Soundbreaking.
I knew that guy was the guy in charge.
The producer.
That's the whole point of having someone like that. Hearing something that you would just discard, and he'll say, hang on a minute, that was really good.
And it's your job to try and make everybody's hair stand on end.
Welcome back to Football Fridays and Georgia's Halftime Show. We're live at MacTharp Stadium in Moultrie, Georgia. Colquitt County leading Lowndes 35-14 in a game that will decide the Region 1 7A Championship for 2016.
And we've already heard from the Lowndes High School Marching Band, but after the game, the Colquitt County Band, the 50th Regiment, will be performing, and we'll be streaming that live on our GPB Sports Facebook page, so make sure that you tune in on Facebook, and then also during the postgame show, hopefully we can cut in and see it. But they will be performing after the game, so don't worry, we will have it, and it'll be streaming live on Facebook. But before all of that, it's time for another show that's the show that's the best one. It's fun, it's quirky, it's Are You Smarter?
It's definitely quirky. What did you know, and when did you know it? Not good questions to hear from the Senate committee answering questions, but it's a piece of cake when you're Are You Smarter. John Nelson's alongside the principal of Colquitt County, Stephanie Terrell.
And we're going to get right to it. You've got a lot of stuff going on, so go right through it.
All right. Yeah, we have a lot of things going on. We have a lot of things to be proud of in Colquitt County. First of all, we had several national winners at the National Ag Conference, and they did an excellent job. We're very proud of them. Our video broadcasting group, they do a lot of live work and shots, and they publicize all of our announcements in the morning. They've worked with y'all some, with GPB TV. It's been really good. Our parent nights have been a very big hit this year. We've taken a different approach, and our parents have been very receptive. They really are enjoying that, and I'm very thankful for our school community, who has raised a lot of money for our local United Way.
All right, time to play the game for a question that neither of us have seen. It's time for a round of Are You Smarter? NBA legend Shaquille O'Neal is dipping a toe into the Atlanta Business Arena, and with a reported shoe size of 23, it's a pretty big toe. What's he doing? Is he restoring the cyclorama at the Atlanta History Center? Is it making the Big Chicken in Marietta his own, or is it a Krispy Kreme on Ponce de Leon Avenue in Midtown? Which one is it?
All right, I like donuts, so I'm going to have to go with C, the Krispy Kreme on Ponce de Leon.
Hot donuts now should be the hashtag. Oh, look at that, hot donuts now. What do you know? It's the Krispy Kreme on Ponce. Shaq says, it just loves donuts. And everyone knows the iconic Krispy Kremes make any donut lover's eyes glaze over. Excellently done, Lisa Clark. Thanks for letting us hang out.
Thank you very much. I appreciate y'all coming back to the cog pen.
Good deal. Good to see you. Back to Are You Smarter? Hot donuts now, everybody.
Well, Shaquille couldn't make free throws, but he can now make glazed donuts, so good for that. Well, here's some scores we're following from all around the state on the Georgia EMC scoreboard. Right now, top-ranked Roswell, no trouble with Woodstock, 52-0. We've got Grayson over Hoover, Alabama, 9-7 in the second quarter. Brookwood leads Norcross in a huge game in Region 7, 15-0 at the half. It is Valdosta leading Coffee by a field goal. Northside Warner Robins over Houston County, 28-21 at the half. Big game. Alexander Mays 7-7 in the first right now. Elsewhere around the great state of Georgia, we have Glenn Academy, no trouble with Effingham County. We've got Buford over Loganville, 28-10. It is Jones County, a touchdown better than Stockbridge. It is Thompson over Burke County by a field goal. Jefferson leads Stevenson County 28-0 in the third quarter. And Benedictine, a winner tonight, 50-0 over Metter.
Lowndes High School Marching Band is still playing, and you can watch them right now live on Facebook Live. Find us on GPB Sports on Facebook, and you can still watch them. They're still playing. Now, it may feel like the season is coming to an end because we are nearing the postseason, but we are just getting started. Here is the schedule brought to you by the Georgia's EMCs. Next Friday, November 4th, is the last week before playoffs. So we're back in the studio covering the whole state to see who makes the brackets. Then the GHSA postseason kicks off for five exciting weeks of playoff football. The first round kicks off November 11th. And then GPB Sports is your source for all high school football for eight championship games in the Georgia Dome December 9th and 10th.
John Nelson rejoins us for another edition of Backroads and Backfields brought to you by the Georgia Cotton Commission.
The natural choice for Georgia.
And this week you hit the road to Cave Spring, Georgia.
Cave Spring, and it was based on a question that we had, and the question was how? So we visited the Georgia School for the Deaf, and the answer is it's not much different than what you're seeing on Football Fridays.
Why? Shotgun. 18. Jeremiah L. Out.
We can play football. If you come and watch, you'll be amazed how we know how we're playing. I thought we can't hear it, but this is how we can play. And people are like, oh, that's how deaf people play. And like, yeah, it's cool. You know, it's kind of cool. Some people can, you know, they don't get the experience of how we play. But you come find tears watch, you understand how you play as a deaf person.
What we want to do is we want to show a lot of excitement, a lot of heart, and leave our hearts on the field, showing that hearing people are wrong and prove to them that deaf can do. We can't. We back us the sign. We as we sign back it up. Can't instead of can't down. It's can't. We take it away. It's fun. It's an enjoyment to watch them. You know, sometimes even the little things. You know, I had a kid this year make a really good tackle one time. It was probably the best tackle he's made all year. But he got up like, I tackled the guy. Yeah, that's what you're supposed to be doing all year. But yeah, great tackle. He says we learned a lot of it by watching colleges and watching other high schools play and different competitions and show them that we can play. Alberto, slot man right, shotgun 18, double flag. Both of you. Pass blocking. Best you guys got pass blocking. As soon as you make the fake, because ain't none of these guys blocking, they're going to give a chicken lock shot and go. You got to get defensive in. If here person comes up and tells me I can't, he says, come on out and I'll show you what I can do.
And Jamond is actually from here. One of his favorite teams, no surprise, your Colquitt County Packers, Mark. So that was an absolute blast to go see the guys up at GSD. And it was one of my favorite stories that I've done here at Georgia Public.
You know, you take us so many great places on back roads and backfields brought to you by the Georgia Cotton Commission.
The natural choice for Georgia.
Great job this week, as always. Let's send it over to Jackie now. Time for a segment we call Rent Check, where we check in with the parents. Jackie?
Thank you, Mark. Joining me now is the Walker family. Their son is Quan Walker. And you guys ready for Rent Check? Woo, woo. All right, let's see if they know the answers. What is Quan's favorite subject in school?
It's got to be math.
What do you think?
Math.
You're both correct. All right, you're one for one. And his favorite pregame meal would be?
Pregame meal. They always eat Chick-fil-A.
Chick-fil-A. See, I told you, moms always know. And then his dream job would be? This is an easy one. I think I know this one.
A rapper.
A career in the music industry. Correct. You guys are three for three. You're going to get some GPB swag. And, Mark, we'll send it back over to you.
All right, way to go, parents. That's the way to go. Time now to send it back up to the booth to Matt and Chuck to call the second half of this game between Lowndes and Colquitt County. But first, we check in the TCSG career play of the game. We'll see you in the postgame show.
I was able to find class times for my welding and joining classes that worked for me, and my tuition was free. I get to train on state-of-the-art equipment, and my instructors are experts in their field. Getting started was easy, and by the time I graduate, I'll already be connecting with companies that need my skills.
The Technical College System of Georgia, creating a better future for you and for Georgia.
Komatsu Forklift of Atlanta. Since 1962, Komatsu Forklift of Atlanta has had a heritage of providing quality material handling solutions to companies of all sizes throughout the state of Georgia. With over 50 years of experience, Komatsu Forklift of Atlanta provides budget-minded solutions in new, used, rental, and parts and service to keep your business running smoothly. Komatsu Forklift of Atlanta, our commitment is built to keep you working longer.
Here, we believe when you study hard, you need to play even harder. Bring your A game, rock the weekend. Climb your way to the top and find your inner champion. World-class faculty and coaches, plus access to over 100 majors, continue our winning traditions. At VSU, you get off the bench and in the game to succeed. Discover Valdosta State University, a hidden gem in higher education.
Welcome back to Moultrie, Georgia, getting ready for the second half here. Colquitt leading Lowndes by the score of 35-14 here with Coach Mack. And I know that those mistakes in the first half were driving you nuts.
Yeah, they do. You know, we dug ourselves a hole. We're just going to have to keep fighting, make some plays.
And at the same time, though, I know that a personal point of pride for you has always been the Mayflower Moving Company, the running game. You were getting those big chunks. I know that you just weren't being able to finish.
Right. You know, we had a couple turnovers, didn't finish a couple drives, and we're having a hard time stopping them. So, we just got to make some plays and keep playing.
All right, go out there and make plays and get playing.
Yes, sir.
Randy McPherson, head coach for Lowndes, getting ready for the second 24 minutes. I think, Matt, you and Chuck have a lot of scoring plays to go over here for the first half, yeah?
Yeah, indeed. And you talked about the Mayflower Moving Company. 216 yards rushing for the Vikings in that first half, yet they find themselves down by three touchdowns as we take a look at the first half highlights.
Well, they've scored, but, you know, they haven't scored enough. Too many turnovers, and just how it's been.
J.J. Peterson with the 98-yard kickoff return touchdown that tied the game at 7 after the 1-yard touchdown run by Michael Barrett. And then Jay Saunders took it in from 3 yards out. Colquitt County had a 14-7 lead. And then following the second of two interceptions thrown by Barrett in the first half, the touchdown pass to Hadley, the tight end, and it was 21-7 after one quarter.
Then Jay Saunders just went bananas. I mean, he just went crazy. Jay Saunders running the ball, throwing the ball, and Michael Barrett, you know, he tries to keep his guys in the game, but he can't do it all by himself. Somebody has to make some plays at the wide receiver position.
That was a 17-yard touchdown run by Barrett, one of his two touchdown runs in the first half, and that was the second of the two touchdown runs by Jay Saunders in the first half, and 35-14, and look at those numbers, 216 on the ground for the Vikings. Yet the two turnovers were the real crushers because the Packers cashed in touchdowns off of both of those turnovers.
Right, and you can't say Lowndes didn't have the ball. They had the ball 14 minutes as opposed to Colquitt's 9. They've had had opportunities, but they just haven't been able to push it in. Those two turnovers, Matt, they were huge because, as you alluded to earlier, they turned into touchdowns.
Yeah, both of them turned into touchdown, interception by Schamberger, interception by Lewis, and two touchdowns scored by the Packers off of those two scores. And, of course, the J.J. Peterson kickoff return was also big. And Lowndes, and you saw the 55 yards passing. Yep. They're missing this guy here tonight, Xavier Jenkins, their highest-rated prospect on the field with offers from Georgia, Louisville, and Mississippi State. He's out with a knee injury. They're hoping to get him back for the playoffs. If not, the first round, certainly, if they can stay alive long enough and get him into the second round and beyond.
Well, Coach McPherson talked about the ability for him to stretch the field, and that's what you lose. So, and if you had your number one receiver and he can get deep, he might have made a couple of those plays that were dropped when Michael Barrett made some great throws.
Your third quarter kickoff is brought to you by Heads Up Georgia. Don't text and drive. Distracted drivers take lives.
Yeah, that's a great point there. Don't text and drive.
Saw plenty of that as we were driving 3.5-4 hours down to Moultrie. Plenty of people with their heads buried in their phones. And the kick is going to be, let's see who got on top of that.
Surprise,
it's going to be the Lowndes' ball, the onside kick, and the Vikings recover.
Coach Randy McPherson has a trick up his sleeve, comes out, comes on with the onside kick. I like it. You got to come out and be aggressive.
So the Lowndes Vikings roll the dice here on the very first play of the third quarter and recover an onside kick, and they will take over at the 50-yard line. Executed by number 30, the kicker, Colton Broom.
Does it go 10 yards here before he touches it? No.
No, it did not. And Rush Probst is very upset. You saw the replay. The ball was touched 8 yards. It's got to go 10, and it looked like it was fielded at the 48-yard line. They spotted it at the 50, but it looked like clearly it was fielded at the 48. Timeout has been called by Colquitt County.
Yeah, and he has every right to want to question that because it didn't go 10 yards, and I could see it with the naked eye. But again, on the field with the human eye, a lot of pieces moving, sometimes these mistakes happen.
Take another look at it right here, and where is the ball touched? It's got to get to the 50, and you can see it's clearly caught at the 48, maybe 49-yard line, short of the 50-yard line, and it had to go 10 yards. So it should be Colquitt County's ball.
Because the philosophy behind it for the receiving team, which is Colquitt County, you got to have an opportunity to make the play. So you got to have an opportunity to get the ball, and if that was the case, everybody would kick it to, 4 and 5 yards.
Yep.
So
Colquitt County still trying to make their argument here. I don't know whether Rush Probst is going to win it. Unfortunately for Rush Probst, they don't have the red flag to throw for a replay in high school football.
But he's getting after him, though. Look, he is riling up the crowd. This Colquitt crowd is loving what Coach Probst is doing, giving them giving them the business. Oh, man.
Well, the Vikings certainly catch a break because it certainly appeared on the replay that they touched the ball. Jahari Barnes was able to grab that ball off the bounce, but it looked like he did it at the 48, maybe 49-yard line when it had to go to the 50. The officials have missed this one, and the Vikings are going to go on offense.
Lowndes wanted a penalty called on Rush because he called a timeout from the numbers. That's what they were talking to the officials about in turn.
Barrett going to take a sack. Tyrese Barge and Denarian Weish with the double team. 11-yard loss.
Well, nice call right here. They send pressure. Tyrese Barge comes off the outside from his coverage position. Catches Michael Barrett off guard. Sack.
10-4.
Nice job by Tyrese Barge.
So second down and 21. Barrett, heavy rush. They set up the screen for Tisdale. Tisdale across the 50, across the 40, and Tisdale down to the 35, picks up the first down.
Nice job by the offensive line of Lowndes, doing a good job on the screen pass. Good job by the running back. We've talked about him the entire game. He's done an excellent job. Travis Tisdale has some jets. It's coming back on Colquitt. The Lowndes faithful are on their feet. Capacity crowd here.
You see Rush Probst asking who the penalty was on. Personal foul on the Packers. So a 15-yard mark off at the end of the run will give the Vikings the ball at the 20-yard line.
Some confidence and guts on Randy McPherson on that sideline. Lowndes, that onside kick has put his team in position to score.
Barrett fires, complete to Kyle, and he got whacked by Barge.
That's a thigh out. The thigh out. But
another flag.
Yep, going to be a personal foul on that. Yep. It's going to be an unsportsmanlike.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. And guess what? He might have hurt himself celebrating.
Yeah.
Pulled something. In the celebration, he snapped those arms out of
the
legs.
I think he landed funny on that ankle as he was celebrating.
Yep. I've seen it before.
We call that a grammatica?
I don't know, man, but he makes a great play here, breaking up the pass. That was a nice thigh out, good competitive nature. But right here, they're not hearing that. That stomp, looks like that stomp, he might have hurt himself.
Well, the officials are going to mark off the unsportsmanlike penalty here.
And what they're saying is no taunting. You made a good play. It's okay to celebrate, but not do it in front of the opponent. Not that kind of celebration.
So 25 yards of this drive for the Vikings have come via Packers penalties. And first and goal to go from the 10-yard line for the Vikings. Pump fake to the corner it goes, and incomplete, looking for Tavon Kyle in the corner.
Overthrows Tavon Kyle. Michael Barrett has been trying to get that pass all game long. It's been a little bit long every time, a little bit long.
Barrett now 5 for 15 in the game passing. Been a tough night for him through the air. He's done his damage on the ground. He's got 2 touchdown runs already tonight. Second down and goal. He'll keep it. And he's going to go right into the end zone. Nothing wrong with his legs, folks.
Man, he is one tough sucker running the ball. Listen, I'm telling you, Michael Barrett, I mean, he's as effective as any running back I've seen this year in any of the games we've ever done. Inside zone play. The bread and butter of the Lowndes Vikings offense. Fake to the outside zone, take it inside. Again, this quarterback, Michael Barrett, does an excellent job of keeping the ball deep in the pocket of the running back, and that's how you're taught to do it. And that's a special skill, Matt, that you have to develop over time, over time. He's going to be a good spread quarterback in college.
Broom with the PAT, and it is 35-21. But remember how this drive started with the break for the Vikings when it clearly appeared that they had illegally recovered an onside kick. A 3-play, 50-yard drive, 25 yards of the 50 yards were Packers penalty yards.
Well, they caught Colquitt off balance. They caught him by surprise, and thumbs up goes to Randy McPherson for making that call. Gets the momentum going on his side in the second half.
All right, Alexander and Mays in a big ball game today.
Riverboat gambler Randy McPherson. So Chuck Smith, help me out. I think it's time we're going to kick it. Yeah,
let's kick it.
All right, kick it. Mays and Alexander. This one was tied at 7 at the half. Mays was up 10-7, and that's where we are until this action happened. Slant and a score. Goes all the way from the left to the right, and it's now 17-7 at that point. It's now 17-14. Mays leading Alexander late second quarter, under 4 minutes to go. Once again, this one. This is a 1 and a 2 by the end when it comes to this region. More updates as we go back upstairs.
Yeah, Alexander undefeated. This is easily the biggest season they've ever had in program history. You see Lowndes with the 3-play, 50-yard drive, and it followed the onside kick recovered by the Vikings. So Randy McPherson's team has cut the Packers' lead to 2 scores.
You made a good point in the first half, talking about the ability of Lowndes. They've been running the ball. They've had a lot of success on the ground, but anytime they tried to throw it, they've had bad luck. But for them to win this game today, Michael Barrett's going to run the ball, but he's going to have to make some plays with his arm also.
And he has not been able to do that thus far tonight. And his receivers at times have not helped him out either. Kick is going to be taken by J.J. Peterson. Watch out for him. He's already taken one back tonight. And Peterson got knocked sideways at the 42-yard line. A big hit on that return, but a big return nonetheless.
That kid has skills. J.J. Peterson, that jump cut he just did was so nasty. Let's just enjoy this. Watch this jump cut right here. Whoop, whoop. I love it. Got to get them shoulders down, though. That hit, they ain't the kind of hit you want, JJ. Yep. You got to protect yourself, buddy.
And he did take a hit. Yeah, He's over there taking a knee on the sideline. Saunders goes right back to the air, throws complete to Ponder. And Saunders has been on the money. 12 of 14 tonight and over 150 yards in the air.
But Saunders has been money. Saunders has been money all night long.
And he's rushed for 85 yards, too.
Yep. Looks like they're going no huddle, trying to up-tempo Lowndes.
First and 10, ball at the Vikings 44. Dejon Edwards gets the handoff, and Edwards going to be tackled by Davis and a host of others at the 40-yard line after a pickup of four.
Really good job by number 40, Jahari Boone, of Lowndes on defense, scraping, just getting to the ball. They're doing a good job of getting those hats over to the ball.
Second down and six, ball at the 40-yard line. Ty Leggett comes into the backfield along with Saunders. After Edwards' run, he comes out. Actually, that's Demarion Moore. Intercepted at the 26-yard line. Fred Stewart going back the other way. Has to beat the quarterback, and Saunders gets him on the ground at the 25. But Fred Stewart with the pick. His second of the season. It's a big one, and the Vikings are this close to being back in the game.
Well, we talked about Lowndes' inability to pressure the quarterback. Finally, the first time in the game, Jay Saunders was threatened. Good pass rush made him get the ball out of his hands fast. And that's how that play was created. Now it's off to the races. Good job, finally. The Lowndes defense gets some pass rush.
So first and 10 now for the Vikings as they take over the Packers 24. And I'm not telling them how to do their business, but I'd run Michael Barrett until he couldn't run it anymore. I'd just keep running him until he couldn't run no more. First and 10. That's what they're going to do. Not much running room for Barrett right there as he gets stopped after just a two-yard gain. J.J. Peterson in on that stop for the Packers.
Marcus Browning, number 82, trying to get a block for Lowndes. Didn't get that block.
16 carries, 93 yards for Barrett tonight. He has scored all three of their touchdowns.
This kid's a beast. I mean, Michael Barrett's a beast.
Hands off to Tisdale this time, and Peterson hits him at the 18-yard line. And you're right. You made a great observation, Chuck. One of the things that makes Barrett so effective on the zone read, whether he hands it off or whether he keeps it, is he holds it deep. He keeps it deep.
It's pretty amazing watching him, how he handles the ball, and that's just one of the things that's special when you're a zone, when you're a spread option quarterback. Two down territory here, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. Third down and three.
They're going to run it with Barrett. I don't. I mean, all I see is a run right here. I'd be surprised if they throw it.
Yeah, don't even second guess yourself. Just let him run it. And he does, and he picks up the first down, and he might have gone the distance had Nelson Lewis not have been able to click his ankles.
Well, nice tackle by Nelson Lewis. It's the Michael Barrett show, number 7 here at Lowndes County. And I don't know how many people up north Georgia have seen this kid and some of these playmakers at night, but this guy right here is beast mode.
Yeah, it looks like he's having some trouble. Mm. Might have some cramping going on in those calf muscles.
He ain't trying to come out. Look.
Yeah, he's in some serious
pain
right now. Let's see if they run it back to him again. They got Tisdale in there. First and 10, they will hand off to Tisdale. And Tisdale, not a lot of running room. Nelson Lewis again on that tackle for the Packers as Tisdale picks up a couple on the play. Tisdale with 111 yards rushing and Barrett with 98.
So Marcus Peterson doing some good work out there defensively. Player two, 47's got some game.
Let's see if Barrett can get through these cramps. Second down and 8 from the 11. They'll hand off to Tisdale again. And Tisdale down to the 7-yard line. I wonder if Colquitt sees the same thing we see, that Barrett's got those cramps. So you know the ball's going to Tisdale.
And Tisdale's been effective, you know, but it's because of the sacrifice that Barnett has been doing.
Yeah. 112 for Tisdale tonight.
Yeah, when he was in that scrum earlier in that drive, first thing he tried to do was stretch his calves at the 45-degree angle. He's not 100%, but he looks like he's working through it.
Let's see if he can run it. He's going to pass it instead on 3rd and 6, and off the hands of Marcus Gary. And it's 4th down. And remember what we told you early in this game. They've only attempted 2 field goal attempts the entire year, and they have not hit one. So here on 4th and 6, don't be surprised if they're going for it, even though the ball is set up right in the middle of the field at the 8-yard line.
Well, there's nothing harder than being in the red zone here backed up, because now it just reduces the throwing area that you can throw. And that's one of the challenges with a quarterback that's having challenges throwing the ball. You're backed up against the end zone. A lot of defenders in that area.
4th and 6 for the 1st down. They need 8 for the touchdown. Barrett, pump fake. Remember, he can't run that well. And he throws incomplete. Tyson Harris pleads with the officials that he caught the ball, but that's an incompletion, and the ball is going to go over on downs.
The walls were closing in on Michael Barrett. Nice rush by Colquitt, making them have to move off the spot. It's incomplete. He gave himself a chance.
They think it was caught, guys.
Yeah, and you can see Barrett is almost immobile.
Well, the eye in the sky don't lie. Here we go.
Now, I think he, you know.
They're working this on 2 fronts. A, they think it was caught, and B, they also think that there was some hand-checking with one of the other receivers here on their side of the field.
That ball was not caught.
It hit the ground.
Yeah.
It's incomplete. Good call by the refs. Nice job, Stripes.
So the Packers take over on offense at the 8-yard line. Handoff goes to Leggett. And that's where the lack of a kicking game really haunts you right there, because Lowndes doesn't get anything. I mean, that ball was at the 8. That's a 25-yard field goal. You should have gotten 3 out of that.
Well, no question about that, and that is the challenge. But also, we've talked about Lowndes' inability to do anything through the air. Less than 75 yards passing. We're 6 minutes in the 3rd quarter.
And it was 4th and 6, and right. Barrett couldn't run it.
Right.
So they had to go through the air. Pass is caught by Schenker. That's his 3rd grab of the game up at the 20-yard line.
Good-looking kid here. That's Schenker. He's a great-looking kid.
Rush Probst said, look, if this kid gets 30 more catches over the next month, basically 30 catches over the next month in the playoffs, we're going to be state champions again, or at least play for it. They think that highly of him. And Rush really feels like what separates his spread offense from a lot of the other spread offenses in the state is that they utilize a bona fide legitimate tight end.
Right, and that's a great option. And I always wonder why more teams don't use that tight end to work that middle.
You got to make the defense defend the middle of the field when you got a tight end that can catch it.
That's right.
Let's see. Do we have an offside here on the Vikings?
There's an alignment. Guy in the neutral zone. Who was that?
So the 5-yard mark off makes it 2nd down and 4. Singletary in motion. They look his way. They throw it to him. Cam Singletary with the catch and run.
Holding.
And we have a flag out on the play as well.
Holding is coming back.
Well, if it's there on the edge, then it's on Ty Powell.
Well, that was a bear hug. That wasn't just regular holding. That was like a bear hug kind of a hold.
That's a happy to see you hold.
Yeah.
Missed you. Haven't seen you in a long time. Yep, holding is the call.
The bad part from the reception standpoint, it didn't have to happen. They already had got around 10, 11 yards. It was a great play. He didn't have to hold him here.
So watch 17 out there on the edge. Yep, there's the hold right there.
And he made a good tackle, though, DB. Yeah, that was unnecessary there. You had a good play. You never want to block behind the ball, or even when the ball is next to you.
So second down after the mark off, and that's going to leave him about 2 yards short of the first down, because the mark off comes from the spot of the foul. Edwards first down. Dejon Edwards with the carry right up the middle. Fred Stewart, who had the pick earlier in this half, makes the tackle.
Well, it's been very interesting for this Lowndes defense. And you remember, they brought out former coach Hiram Johnson. He was called out of retirement, and they've said that he's been the big difference. Randy McPherson said he's been the big difference for the turnaround of this defense. But they're going to need a lot of Hiram Johnson magic to slow down this Colquitt offense.
First and 10, ball at the 37. Trying to get the ball to Dejon Edwards. Nice coverage right there. David Shores, the defensive coordinator there in the black shirt for the Lowndes Vikings. He actually worked for Rush Probst at Hoover for a couple of seasons, where he was Rush's defensive line coach and special teams coach on two of their five state championship teams. He left Hoover and went to LSU to be on Nick Saban's staff,
which had, I mean, so many college head coaches. I mean, he's a great coordinator. He's got a great staff.
This is his second year at Lowndes. He was at Peach County before that, 13 years in the state of Alabama. And Fred Stewart with a nice open field tackle, dropping Dejon Edwards in his tracks for a loss.
Well, I'm telling you, at halftime, you can see the difference. The adjustments have been made for this Lowndes defense. They're swarming. They look like they got a little pep in their step. They ate their spinach.
Fred Stewart's had himself a big quarter. David Shore says he's the most physically gifted player on defense, an intimidating tackler.
Let's see if they send any kind of pressure. See what the pass rush looks like. It's going to be huge on this play.
And incomplete on the sideline. Brent Carter on the coverage kept Torrey Ponder from making the catch. That is the first third down that the Packers have failed to convert tonight.
Nice job by Lowndes getting the quarterback off the spot. Jay Saunders couldn't sit back there. He did break contain. You don't want that. Nice coverage by the Vikings. Big, big, big play.
Schenker, the punter, of course, also the tight end, stands at the 19-yard line to kick. That's a nice kick from him. Harris is going to take it at the 28. And Harris spins forward to the 38. 10-yard return for Tyson Harris. And the Vikings go back on offense, down two touchdowns and 3.5 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Matt Stewart along with Chuck Smith, John Nelson, and the GPB team as we are bringing you this South Georgia Classic, the 41st all-time meeting between these two Region 1 rivals.
I got a feeling of the momentum seems to have changed a little bit here. I mean, I just kind of feel a momentum shift as I'm watching Colquitt. They don't have that extra bounce in their step right now. Looks like Lowndes has it. And if they score here, it's going to be interesting going into that fourth quarter. We talked about the 4 minutes in the fourth quarter.
We could be headed for that as we are late in the third and a timeout called on the field.
Game day brings out the best in all of us. At Regions, every day is game day.
what is by moonlight an empty field is by the magic of electricity, sacred ground. As the official energy provider of the GHSA, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives proudly support our student athletes. We're there, illuminating the glory moments fans just have to see. Capturing the hustle, elevating champions, sharing the win. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
.334 to play in the third quarter. Colquitt County with a 35-21 lead on Lowndes. As we take a look at something we call the Packers peak performers, some of the great football players walk through the halls of Colquitt County High School. One that's currently in the NFL, that's Cameron Irving, who went on to star at Florida State, first round draft pick, number 19 pick in the 2015 draft, and now playing for the winless Cleveland Browns. But he's getting paid.
He's getting paid. You got my boy on there, D.E. Antonio Edwards, a.k.a. Yuck. That was his nickname.
And of course, the legendary Ray Goff was the quarterback here. Went on to be the SEC Player of the Year at the University of Georgia, leading the Dogs to the 1976 SEC Championship and Sugar Bowl. And the Lowndes legends, I know you played with some Randall Godfrey,
yeah,
didn't you?
He lives in my neighborhood. Yeah. Our kids in the North Gwinnett cluster. No, love me some Randall, man.
Yeah, Jay Ratcliffe, who went on to play with the Cowboys. Telvin Smith is currently, he's the only Lowndes Vikings alumni still playing in the NFL right now. Telvin Smith with the Jacksonville Jaguars. They got a difficult loss last night against the Tennessee Titans. Telvin Smith also played at Florida State. He was a fifth-round pick out of Tallahassee in the 2014 draft.
You got to come out running, right? You got your guy Michael Barrett. He's been dominant all day running the ball.
Well, hopefully they were able to hydrate him over there and get him over the cramps. Let's see if because that's really what killed their last drive, that they took away that aspect of their offense. He's going to hand it off again. They're going to throw a pass. Harris throws it downfield. It's caught at the 45-yard line by Tavon Kyle. A couple of spin moves, and Kyle finally down to the 20-yard line. Tyson Harris with his second completion of the season. It worked again.
Nice work here. You got a sweet pass. He throws it with all his might, too, falling backwards. That was a nice job. Tyson Harris gets that thing out of his hand. Nice throw. Good job. Good job, Tavon Kyle, on the catch and run. They're in it. Here they come.
42-yard completion as Tisdale gets the handoff. Tisdale weaving through traffic inside the 5-yard line.
Outside zone. You got the offensive line now from Lowndes County. They are coming downhill, making big blocks. It looks like you got about 15 offensive linemen on the field. They're just everywhere. Good job by Tisdale. Travis Tisdale, number 6, just a sophomore compared to some of the great young backs.
And a great block thrown by the left guard, Danny Corbett, out there on the edge to get him a few more yards. First and goal to go for the Vikings. And Barrett doesn't quite have that same drive that he's had. And I don't know whether it's the cramps that have slowed him down a little bit, but he didn't still have that. He didn't have that force when he hit the tackler this time, did
he? Well, he didn't have that force. Maybe he did a little bit, but they put that thing on him. Hey, it was about five defenders hit him at the exact same time. Still scrapping, though. Yep.
And he comes to the sideline.
Yeah.
It's his shoe. He's having trouble getting his shoe on. Play clock is down to 11 already, and he's just now getting to the huddle. They're going to have to hustle here. Play clock at 6.
Is this a sneak again?
4.
Uh-oh.
Handoff, and Harris gets in for the touchdown. Tyson Harris, who threw the 42-yard pass to get him down close, then runs it in, and it is now 35-27.
Off-tackle power, flexing their muscle on the goal line, taking it out of Michael Barrett's hands. Good job by Tyson Harris, running, getting that ball over the goal line. We have a game here, guys.
Uh-oh. And they're going to run a 2-point conversion, and they get it in.
Marcus Gary takes it in on the two-point conversion into the corner, and now it's a six-point game.
Man.
How about Randy, the riverboat right. gambler, Randy McPherson, on three separate occasions in this half, they've come up with big plays to flip the script. They recovered an onside kick. They threw a halfback pass, and then they run a two-point conversion.
Man, they haven't won a region championship since 2010. They are hungry, Matt. You're going to do what you got to do. He's coming to play to win here. Excellent job. Here's the play that makes it all happen. I'm telling you, Tyson Harris, this court, they had a sweet pass. Gets the ball down to Tavon Kyle. He runs and dances and dips and dives and I mean, gets him in position to score this touchdown. Nice off power here again. Tyson Harris does a good job getting that ball over. And here's where the riverboat gambler, Randy McPherson, comes into play. They go for two, giving a boost of confidence like you've never seen here in this rivalry as of late.
I tell you what, they have come up big on three separate occasions in this third quarter to get back in this ball game. They were down 35-14 at the half, and now they're down only 35-29. And remember, they were inside the 10 and turned the ball over on
right,
downs.
Right.
They could be in the lead right now.
Right. And I was talking to our John Nelson. I got to give him credit. We talked before the game. This is a second half team. This Lowndes team, this ain't the first time they've gotten behind and came back rolling in the second half and had a big win.
And the kickoff's going to be taken by J.J. Peterson. He has trouble picking it up and finally does at the 8-yard line. And Peterson, man, I mean, there's some hitting going on that kickoff. And Peterson gets dropped at the 12-yard line. So very poor field position for the Colquitt County Packers as they go back on offense with a 1:50 left in the third quarter.
Guys, let me go back to the two-point conversion. They stopped Gary as he was putting his helmet on, coming off the sideline, whispered in his ear, and that was the trigger for that two-point to use him as the hammer to cut this to a six-point game.
Wow, what a game. And it looks like Peterson's a little bit shaken up as he goes to the sideline. So the Packers back on offense, and the Vikings have grabbed the momentum. Handoff. Nope, keeper by Saunders. And Saunders picks up maybe three on the play.
I love a game when every play is contested. Every play is the next big play. Both of these teams wanting to win this region. There's only going to be one winner, but what a heck of a game. These guys are really competing.
Well, and you heard Nelly tell you in the opener, it's the region trophy, of course, that you want, but it's also the playoff bracketing that you want as well. The number one seed in this region compared to the number two seed, it's a whole different bracket that you got to play through to try to get to the Georgia Dome. Second down and six. Saunders, heavy rush, hit as he throws. Got it to Schenker, and he dropped it. They're going to rule that an incomplete. I think it was Jeffrey Davis that caused him to drop it.
Elgin Griffin, number 90, 6'2", 265, gets the first hit on Jay Saunders today. Big hit on the quarterback, roughing him up a little bit. I like that number 90. Yeah. Ballers wear number 90, y'all.
It looked good on you.
Keep wearing that, young man. I like it. Nice inside pass rush move. Gets a nice hit on Saunders. I told you, man, looks like Lowndes County's eating their spinach, man. They got a little more pep in their step than Colquitt. Colquitt has got to score. They haven't scored in this half after putting 35 up in the first half.
Final minute of the third quarter. Saunders, that is complete over on the far side. That goes to Torrey Ponder for a first down.
He had a clean pocket, didn't Jay Saunders had a lot of time. The key is going to be pressure.
Yep.
They have to get pressure, talking about the Vikings' defensive front.
Well, Chuck, we have seen when Saunders is given time, he's going to dice you up.
Yeah, he is. I mean, has time to look at his second look. He looked at three different receivers. Nice progression.
Now, that was a good look right there as Edwards gets the handoff, and Edwards picks up about six, maybe seven on the play. But that was a good replay because you could see his eyes, mm-hmm. and he's knocking them down. One,
right.
Two, three.
Right.
What you got down there on Michael Barrett?
A lot of folks would have to pay good money for the hour to get the massage he's been getting over the last couple of minutes. Both calves iced, and a lot of fluids were going into Barrett as he gets ready for the fourth, guys.
They're going to need him. Second down. And nothing doing. Dejon Edwards got stonewalled at the line of scrimmage. And that was Tommy Owens, big number 44, as the fourth quarter is upon us.
The fingers are up for number four.
Wow, look at this.
This place is awesome.
Third quarter is done in Moultrie, Georgia. The quarter started with an onside kick that may have been illegally recovered by the Vikings, but they cashed in on that break on the Michael Barrett touchdown run. And then Tyson Harris took it in as well. It is a six-point game as we head to the fourth.
At 60 miles per hour, you go the length of a football field in 5 seconds. But would you do it blindfolded? When you text and drive, that's what happens. Heads up, Georgia. Texting and driving is against the law.
Support for GPB comes from Georgia Farm Bureau Mutual Insurance. From front porches to back roads, down the street or around the block, Georgia Farm Bureau is there with the protection families need, whether it's home, auto or life insurance, or something more. Georgia Farm Bureau is dedicated to providing the right coverage to all the friends, families, and neighbors who
to your team like never before with the GPB Sports Football app. Get the latest news. Watch featured games live wherever you are.
Look at that. Look at that.
Find relevant info on schools and take interactive 3D tours of stadiums around the state. Tweet game highlights from the stands and get up-to-the-minute scores all Friday night. The gridiron has gone digital. Download the free GPB Sports Football app from the iTunes App Store now.
Third down and two for Colquitt County as we start the fourth quarter. Matt Stewart, Chuck Smith, John Nelson, and the GPB team with you at the Hog Pen, MacTharp Stadium in Moultrie, Georgia. The Region 1 7A Championship on the line here tonight. The Vikings have scored 15 unanswered points here in the second half to cut the Packers' once 21-point lead to 6. Ball at the 35. Hand off to Edwards, and Edwards will not get there. And I think that was Devon Holmes. Jeffrey Davis in on that play as well, and now it's going to be fourth down, and let's see. They haven't sent the punt unit on yet. Now they do on fourth down and two in their own end.
Nice job by number 40, Devon Holmes. Senior, 6'1", 275, coming down that line, making the initial hit. Then a host of Vikings came down to get the ball carrier down.
Schenker standing at the 23 to punt. Flag out as soon as the ball was snapped. He booms it over the heads of the backs. It's going to hit at the 20 and roll. 5 yards dead at the 15, but let's check the flag here. Lowndes might make him kick it again. Yeah, illegal shift is going to be the call on the Packers, and so the Vikings are going to make him kick it over.
Coach Probst talked about limiting the mental errors, the mistakes. It's starting to come back and bite them in the butt. They got to pull it. They got to pull it together. Yeah. They're going to win this game because right now, Lowndes is fighting. Lowndes is feeling themselves, and Lowndes feels like you can see in the second half. I talked about the momentum shift. You can kind of look at the players, the way they move, and you could just tell. It's just something I've over the years of watching ball, and you could kind of see Lowndes with a little more pep in their step.
So Schenker gonna punt again. This time he's standing at his 17 with the ball at the 30. Harris and Kyle deep for the Vikings. Back around their own 30. And the play gets blown dead again, this time before they could kick it.
Are they a line wrong? I'm trying to figure out what it is. Is it another?
The illegal procedure this time.
Okay.
That's back-to-back, a shift penalty and now a procedure right. penalty on the punt team for the Packers.
Yeah, and I was wondering with this exotic look, you got to have a minimum of 7 offensive linemen on the line to have a legal formation. So that wasn't it. I thought that might be it the first time, but it's really exotic formations right now. And Colquitt right now is reeling.
So now they'll try to punt again. And Schenker standing at his 11. Try to set up a return. And they kick it over the head of Kyle. It takes a bounce backwards in favor of the Vikings. And the Packers finally get on top of it at the 41-yard line. So great field position for the Vikings as they take over their first possession of this fourth quarter, 59 yards away from tying the game.
I remember in our pregame, we talked about our Komatsu forklift keys to the game. Michael Barrett has to win this game for his team. And it's really shocking to me a little bit here. We talked about he'd have to throw. He's done this with his legs. I mean, him and Tisdale have basically ran the ball to get this team back in the game, which is shocking versus a defense like Colquitt.
So Barrett's had some time to get hydrated, get a massage on those calf muscles. That's Gary, the tight end in motion. He scored that 2-point conversion late in the third quarter. Handoff goes to Tisdale. Tisdale with 132 yards rushing tonight. You throw in Barrett's 98.
Well, Bubba Walker, the defensive coordinator at Colquitt County, he's trying to throw everything but the kitchen sink up at him, and they can't stop the run. They're having problems stopping the run, so that tells me the offensive line from Lowndes County has taken control.
Vikings have over 250 yards rushing in this game. Tisdale gets it again. Got a nice block on the edge. And Tisdale across the 50-yard line has a first down.
I'm going to tell you this. Hunter Finley, number 68. Kendrick Gray, 54. Palmer Henderson, the center, 51. Danny Corbett. They're firing off the ball. I'm telling you, like, watch them fire off the ball. Boom. Look at that. The double team. Kendrick Gray coming off the senior, 6'4", 290, getting after it.
First and 10 from the 44. Michael Barrett across the 30, the 20, and Barrett down to the 12-yard line before finally being stopped by Caleb Dawson.
Give this offensive line credit again. Kendrick Gray, 54, the right side of that offensive line. Then they bring Danny Corbett, number 52. He's pulling. I mean, he's rolling. I mean, he looks like a receiver, a big giant receiver.
But we do have a flag down on the field. It's going to erase that big run by Michael Barrett.
But we talked about enacting your will upon someone. What you see right now, Lowndes, they're physically taking this defense apart right now, Colquitt County, with physical football, running ball. There's nothing more demoralizing than when you can't stop the run. I've been on many games like this. It's nothing worse, nothing you do, but they got to figure it out. Colquitt has to man up.
So a holding penalty against the Vikings. Instead of having the ball inside the 15, they're way back now at their own 49-yard line. Costly penalty. Tisdale, he's going to be caught behind the line of scrimmage. Big tackle by Kamari Lewis to drop him for a loss.
Nice play. Nice TFL. Tackle for loss. Good job right here staying outside. He has outside containment. That's where he's supposed to be. Good job. That was a safety that time. He was a forced player. Good job.
So now it's second down and 20. Barrett across the middle and open. Tisdale inside the 20. And Caleb Dawson, a touchdown saving tackle. Wow, how did Tisdale get so wide open, Chuck?
Well, I'll tell you how it got wide open. He goes right up the seam, and what's been happening, Colquitt County's been playing a run. They can't stop the run, so now they put everybody in the box. He just gets vertical. He just goes downhill, gets vertical on a deep route, and the safeties are playing run, so they're close to the line.
It was a 39-yard gain. Tisdale gets the rock again, and Tisdale running hard, stopped at the 10-yard line, picked up 6 on the play.
I keep thinking of what John Nelson said early before the game. Lowndes County Vikings are a second-half team. They're rolling, Nelly. You were right.
They are, and you got a sophomore who was clocked at 4-2 at the Kirby Smart Camp on the hands, and he's learned how to bounce in his sophomore year, too.
Second down and 3.
Tisdale's going places, man. He's a good one.
Tisdale tries to get around the edge, and nice open field tackle by Caleb Dawson to keep him from turning the corner, and now it's going to be third down.
So what do you notice now a little bit here, Matt? Every person that's making a tackle is a defensive back.
Mm-hmm.
Linebackers, the first level, D-line, they've been getting manhandled. Second line, linebackers hadn't been there. Now you see corner safeties making the tackles. That's not a good recipe here for Colquitt going to our 4 minutes. Because when that 4 minutes gets here, that's going to be one of our Komatsu keys to the game. We're going to see if it shows up.
About a half yard short.
Vikings are 4 of 8 on their third downs. They're 1 for 1 this half. You heard Nelly tell you it's about a yard, less than that. And that is a first down as Barrett just bulls his way forward for the first down, and it's first and goal to go for the Vikings.
Man, I love it. They got them wide bodies butt to butt. Palmer Henderson, the center, 51. Danny Corbett, 56, offensive guard. Man, they got them big butts side to side, and they got a running quarterback that can't be stopped.
First and goal to go for the Vikings. 7.5 minutes to play in regulation. Keeper Barrett bounces outside, gets into the end zone for the touchdown, and we are tied at 35.
All I can say is, wow. If you would have told me in the going at 7 minutes and 18 seconds that we'd have a 35-35 tie the way it was going for Lowndes County. Remember, the big story right now, Colquitt County has not scored in the second half.
They've been outscored 21 to nothing.
Look at the baby-faced assassin, Michael Barrett. Got that beard already, man. What you doing with that beard, young as you are? Good-looking young man, going to have a bright future.
Broom on for the PAT to give the Vikings the lead. Ball is bobbled and blocked. They never got the snap down. And we're tied at 35. Second week in a row here on GPB, we've seen a PAT factor in big.
It was so natural for me to say, what is that? Hold on, he kicked it. Then he tried to kick it again, right? Well, that just shows you they don't have a great kicking game. But again, that was a little different, but they got the momentum.
Michael Barrett with 3 touchdown runs tonight. 4 touchdown runs tonight with this one. We're tied at 35 in the fourth quarter.
How affected someone is by it. Proprio 5000, it gives us baseline data on someone's balance. There's a 2-minute test that we do, and it gives them an objective score on that balance test. We want to make sure that they're, 95% plus before they get back to the game.
National Beef is proud to support the South Georgia Gridiron Classic, serving over 1 million pounds of beef products weekly to tens of thousands of families throughout the region. National Beef is a proud member of the Moultrie and Colquitt County community. Whether you plan to attend a 2-year college, 4-year university, or go straight into the world of work, the Georgia Career, Technical, and Agricultural Education programs teach students essential career skills through real-world experiences and on-the-job training.
18 to go regulation. We are tied at 35 at the hog pen. And Chuck Smith, it's time to kick it.
Let's kick it.
And show you what's going on with Mays and Alexander. This one has gone back and forth. It was 17-14 Mays at recess. Then you get a long touchdown by Alexander. And that's why we show things going from all the way from the right-hand side of the screen to the all way to the left-hand side of the screen to make it 21-17. But 8:29 and counting. In the third, Mays comes back for a score, 24-21. Mays leading Alexander. Houston County may live to see game 10. They are leading with 4 minutes to go over Northside. And Chuck, by the way, North Gwinnett is winning big 42-7. Back upstairs for the rest of the fourth.
The crowd goes wild in Sewanee.
All right, well, here's a look back at the PAT. Remember last week in our Brookwood Parkview game, the missed PAT in overtime ended the game. This PAT would have been for the lead. And the snap was just bobbled, and then the kick.
He Charlie Browned him with the ball.
Watch number 85, Christopher Foster. He bobbled it, then he put it down, and then he moved it right when he tried to kick it.
Then he got thigh out on. I hadn't seen that one, but he Charlie Browned him like
he did.
Like,
watch him. Now they got it set up. Now he's going to kick it. No, he moved it.
That's what you
What was he doing?
Ooh, then he took a thigh out hit. Oh, my goodness.
Chuck, why did he pick up the ball?
I don't know. I mean, I guess he was trying to
reposition
replace it.
Yeah, I guess
he's going to try to reposition it.
Well, it's a lot easier for us. We're just chuckling because it was a humorous play.
Because of the missed kick, not at the kid. But, valiant effort. But, again, that's a big play in this game.
But we saw it happen last week, the Brookwood Parkview game that went to overtime here on GPB. Parkview scored a touchdown to make it 24-23 in overtime. They just had to kick the PAT to send it to a second overtime, and they missed it. And here, Lowndes, having scored 21 consecutive points, all they got to do is get the 22nd point for the lead. It just shows you the PAT is important.
It's huge. I mean, special teams.
Yeah.
I mean, both coaches talked about the importance of the special teams. You've seen Colquitt, they've had a return for a touchdown, and then you saw that play there. So,
well, it's like the old commercial about your car. There are no unimportant parts in the football. There are no unimportant plays.
Preach on, Matt. Preach on.
So we're tied at 35 with 7:18 to go, and Eric Paulo will kick off for the Vikings. Kick's going to be taken at the 9-yard line. And Dejon Edwards battles forward to about the 32.
Lowndes
says
out?
They've got it. And no indication yet from the officials. The officials, I believe, say it was dead. Bob Preston's our referee, and Bob Preston has not given us a signal.
Well, don't worry. The GPB eye in the sky don't lie. We'll get to the bottom of it here in a second.
Did we have a penalty flag, too? I think we had a penalty flag, too. Mm-hmm. We do. We have a holding on the Packers.
In a tough half for the Packers. Penalty setting them back. Big plays. Inability to run the ball. Inability to throw the ball. Jay Saunders, big first half. Hasn't had that magic in the second half. Give a lot of credit. Give a lot of credit to Lowndes County.
Okay, Dejon Edwards on the return.
Inconclusive.
Yeah, the ball came out, but it looked like he was clearly already stopped.
Yep. I thought his momentum would stop. Good call.
So let's see if the Packers can get some momentum of their own here. They haven't been able to do anything in this half.
D-line has been stout now. I'm telling you, Lowndes County, they went in the locker room. Randy McPherson must have lit them up a little something. But they're doing an excellent job stopping the run. They've completely taken the run away from the Colquitt County.
David Shore is their defensive coordinator, signaling in the plays. Second down and 6. Ball is at the 15-yard line. Saunders fires complete at the 20-yard line. Edwards with the catch, and let's see, did he get the first down or might be a little bit short?
Rushing 3, dropping 8. Guys are dropping pretty deep. simple curl route by the receiver. Good throw by Jay Saunders.
A little bit short, third down and one. Let's see, they spot the ball on the 20-yard line. They got to get to about the 20 and three quarters, I think.
This is a big play. You don't want to give Michael Barrett that ball back again. They're hot right now. You got to make a play here, try to get some points.
Late man on the field for the Packers. And a timeout called by Colquitt County.
Well, remember, let me tell you now, coming back with the timeouts, remember Coach Probst used a timeout early on the onside kick.
Right, they only have one
left.
He used that timeout to argue.
Yep.
And now he's down to one to go in a tie ball game.
In that last play, you had a runner coming on the field. They only had 10 men on the field. Another mistake that's coming back to bite him in the butt. Right now, just the tempo, and right now, it's not going Colquitt County's way.
Chuck, what happened to the Packers here in the second half? Remember when Nelly talked to Rush Probst at halftime, he said we got to come out and approach the second half like it's 0-0, but they haven't done that.
And I respect what Coach Probst said, because remember, he said that these games always come down to the second half, and it was hard for me to see it. I mean, the way it was going, completely dominating. Did they take the pedal off the metal, the players? Did they get complacent? And I doubt that because the region championship's on the line, but let's give Lowndes County a lot of credit. These games are about making adjustments. You go in the locker room, you want to make adjustments, and they've clearly made the right adjustments, and they've been rolling ever since.
Well, here's what's at stake. Winner of this ball game is going to finish 3-0 in the region. They will be the champion and the number one seed going into the state playoffs. The loser will be 2-1 and the number two seed going into the state playoffs. Third down and one right here. And handoff, first down carry.
Big play right there.
And Ty Leggett on the carry. Got two when he needed just about one, so more than enough. And the Packers keep the drive alive. Well, Rush told us when we spoke to him on the phone this week, Chuck, that he said, look, I see this game going down to the final 4 minutes with us or Lowndes having the ball and a chance to win, and it looks like that's going to be the case.
So true.
Saunders, given time, pumps it downfield, and it is caught by Sharonsky Sloan for a first down at the 44-yard line.
Well, that's the big challenge. Anytime you rush three, you got five protectors. Excellent protection again by the Colquitt offensive line. Jay Saunders has a clean pocket. No one in his throwing lanes. He's able to deliver the ball right where he needs it to be for a big first down.
221 yards passing for Saunders tonight, and a timeout has been called by the officials. I believe Tommy Owens, the linebacker, was stumbling off the field. He got shaken up on that tackle, and he couldn't quite get to the sideline before collapsing. So that stops the clock with 5:36 to play. 5.5 minutes left to decide the Region 1 7A championship, and we'll have that 5.5 minutes when we get back.
Football Fridays on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations, so much more than electricity. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. Cigna, together all the way. And viewers like you, thank you.
Symbols of wealth and beauty.
It's the beauty of the stone. You can just sit for hours just drooling over it.
But what do they tell us about our planet?
Our Earth is a master chef. She knows how to cook.
Now, the stories behind the most exquisite treasures of the Earth. On Nova.
Part of GPB's Why Wednesday, this Wednesday at 9.
From I Have a Dream to I Can't Breathe. From Straight Outta Compton to the White House. Black history is American history.
You must not
Black America since MLK, and still I rise.
Tied at 35 with 5:36 to play. Let's check in with John Nelson.
All right, we're going to do this a little differently. Chuck, get those magic words for me.
Let's kick it.
All right, but we're going to come back on camera to do it because we want a Grayson Hoover update. Third quarter, Garrett Farquhar to Joseph Timpa, and this is a game at Hoover Met, and here's how it happened. So, Wesley, tell me if I have to tilt it backwards or forwards. There it is right there. There's how it happened. So 22-14, and there's your proof. So back upstairs. You got to love modern technology, guys, right?
It's pretty cool. You can watch any game anywhere, anytime.
Yep. I'm glad you got rid of that old flip phone, old man, catching up with these
Mark
millennials.
Mark Harmon, however, still only has 1G on his new phone. One.
Mark don't got a flip, does he? Can't even text nobody
on
the flip.
Yeah, actually, he does. He got rid of his flip. He's got a late 20th century phone.
There you go.
Close.
Well, Rush Probst told us that we were going to get a true taste of what South Georgia football is all about tonight. And he even went as far as to say the game would be one for the ages. I was a little skeptical when he said that. But it's been a real good one, no doubt about it. First and 10 for the Packers at their own 45. And Ty Leggett down the sideline. He will score.
Man, Ty Leggett put that head back. He was gone. When you see that head go back, you know he's running hard. Outside zone play. Nice work. Big touchdown. Huge play. Finally, Colquitt gets on the board in the second half.
First points of the second half for the Colquitt County Packers, and they are back on top, 41-35. Now, as we've already seen in this ball game, the all-important PAT makes it 42-35. Ty Leggett with a 55-yard touchdown run as we take a look at your TCSG touchdown replay.
Well, great blocking. Everybody gets a body on the body. Ty Leggett takes it to the house. Look, he got the head going back like a dog chasing after him. When the dog chasing after you in your neighborhood, you just throw your head back.
And run as hard as you can.
You just be rolling.
You try to get as aerodynamic as possible.
I love it, Ty. Throw the head. Look at him like he just hit a 40.
Yeah,
he 4, just, 2, 3.
He just broke the tape.
Great blocking again. Big time play. Now, let's see what happens. Can Michael Barrett and the Lowndes County Vikings answer? But the key is, are they going to try? If they score, do they try the field goal again? You got to go for two. It could come down to a two-point game. A two-point opportunity, let me say.
Five plays, 89 yards, and the final 55 covered by the churning legs of Ty Leggett. 42-35 for the Region 1-7A championship. Yeah. What fun we've had tonight at the Hog Pen. And I wrote in my blog this week that if we're going to the Hog Pen, we better have some good barbecue, and we had that too.
Yeah, we did, man. Shout out to my new buddy, Joe Kim.
Yeah.
The best barbecue sauce in the state of Georgia. The Chamber's been great too. Chamber here of Moultrie. Great hospitality.
Maligon kicks it through the back of the end zone, and so the Lowndes Vikings will start at their 20-yard line. That has not been a problem for them tonight. They've had drives of 80 yards, and they've had drives of 59 yards, 50 yards. Their first drive of the night was an 11-play, 80-yard drive to get on the board, so they've done it before.
Well, here's where rubber meets the road. You know what Lowndes does best, run the ball with Michael Barrett and Tisdale. And what has been the Achilles heel so far for Colquitt here in the second half? Stopping the run. I mean, it's going to be, hey, you either get it done or you don't, because you know what they're going to do. But Michael Barrett's going to have to make a pass or two on this series if they're going to score.
They have all three timeouts remaining. Blitz coming off the edge, and Barrett going to bounce to the outside. He's got 10. He's got 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 39 yards on the carry for Michael Barrett. I love that kid. He is so much fun to watch.
Well, you see here, they send pressure. They send Tyrese Bard, so Colquitt sends a blitz. Michael Barrett breaks the blitz, and when you send a blitz, you're limited in the back end, so there was one less guy back there. They send two yep. safeties, and that's where Michael Barrett was able to have a big play off of the pressure sent by Colquitt County.
You are so right, big Chuck Smith. If you're going to send the blitz, you better get him. Barrett again, and Barrett down to the 32-and-a-half-yard line as he gets another 8 yards on the play. 22 carries now for Barrett. He is right at 150 yards rushing tonight.
And I'd probably say he's really ran the equivalent of 250 dragging people with him.
Yeah.
He's like, wait. I bet you if you counted the broken tackles after this week, I mean, 25, 30. I mean, an unbelievable number of breaking of tackles he's broke today.
Second down and one from the 32. If you're Lowndes, you don't want to score too fast. Barrett, first down carry and a body slam by Brian Merritt.
And slammed him for a first down. He slammed him forward for about another extra 2 yards. But that's how you want to take him down hard and heavy. But this dude is tough. Michael Barrett's tough, I mean.
He's tough, but he's got some bumps and bruises.
Oh, he's going to need the ice tub tomorrow now. We were talking about the ice tubs earlier in the NFL. That's one of the things that you got to have.
Yep.
He's going to have some ice bags on him tomorrow. I mean, this kid is, I mean, given a valiant effort, but both teams are balling. But it's coming down to the 4 minutes.
Yep.
Here we go.
We are under 4 minutes to play. First and 10 for the Vikings. Ball at the Packers 28. Play got blown dead. Ooh. Penalty is going to be on the Vikings, I believe.
Ooh, lucky for Colquitt. They had a seam and had a great play on that one. Tisdale had some running room.
5 yard mark off here against the Vikings. And, you know, Randy McPherson and Rush Probst got together when they put together this region schedule and they saw they're going to play their game the final week of the season. Well, they said, well, let's move it up. Let's play it on the 28th and get ourselves a week off before the playoffs start, because mm-hmm. they knew both teams were going to be beat up really bad after this game.
Oh, there's some bumps and bruises out yeah. there. This is the most physical game I've had the chance to call this year. I mean, two really great teams.
The good news is they're going to week to rest before the playoffs start, regardless of whether they win or lose. Barrett on the carry inside the 30 and down to the 29. Now, remember, the Packers are down to one timeout, so they don't have a great opportunity. They can't control the clock defensively because they only have that one timeout, and the Vikings still have all three of theirs. And if I am the Vikings, I'm going to snap the ball as late on the shot clock or play clock right. as I can, because I don't want to score and leave too much time right. for the Packers.
Man, I'm seeing a run or maybe even a screen at some point here.
Wow, they're going to throw the ball. Yep. It's been a while since they've been able to do that. Gary makes the catch, but he doesn't get to the outside as Kamari Lewis made a nice tackle. And Marcus Gary is hurt.
Got an injury here.
Yep. Marcus Gary slow to get up.
Short pass, didn't get much out of that. It's a big play here. Just a simple out route. They're just trying to go 5 yards upfield and just go towards the sideline. Excellent defense by the Packers.
Third down and 10. They've got to get to the 19.
I don't think running's out of the picture here, though.
I don't think it is. I'd run it. Okay. But they're not going to. They're going to pass. Going up top for Tisdale. He caught it. Yep. No, he didn't. He dropped it. Broken up. Nice play on the edge by Willie DeBruce, the linebacker, to separate Tisdale from the ball. And now it's fourth down and 10. Yeah, nice play. The ball got there, and so did Willie DeBruce at the same time, and the Vikings just burned a timeout.
Nice touch by Michael Barrett here. He has to have that. That's a play you got. You got to make that catch. Tough catch, but you can make that catch. But a nice design play, even better play on the defense.
You surprised they went to the air back-to-back there? They went to Gary on the edge, and then they went to Tisdale downfield instead of running Barrett.
Well, I thought their tendency is because they've been successful in the run, they do that. But I know that you're going to have to make a play with your arm here at some point. There's no way that you're going to run all the way downfield. Well, I just thought that there's an opportunity to catch him off guard.
They've
like
done
that.
It tonight.
Yeah, they caught him off guard there. There was an opportunity. But here, I'd give him a run pass opportunity, get him out of the pocket, let him do his thing.
All right, let's check in Mays and Alexander with Nelson when we kick it.
Once again, Chuck Smith, help me out. What are we doing?
We're going to kick it.
So kick it, and we'll give you your update with Mays and Alexander. They are now late third quarter. You see what it was in the third at 21-17. This one's gone back and forth all the way through. Mays makes it 24-21. Then it was 31-28, Mays. That was with a minute and 40 to go in the third. So that's your update with Mays and Alexander. They're going at it with haymakers third quarter back upstairs.
We got haymakers being thrown here tonight. Vikings now have only two timeouts remaining, and it's fourth down and 10.
I'd get him out. I'd get Michael Barrett out the pocket, let him roll to the right, give him a run pass opportunity.
They stack the wide receivers, yep. 1, 2, 3. This is going to be a double pass. Kyle picks it up and throws it to Barrett. That's an incompletion.
They had it.
And they had it set
play.
Up. Yep.
They had a great play.
And Kyle couldn't get Barrett the pass. Man.
Both passes were a little low. The timing was off.
Well, I think the pass to Kyle was intentionally low to try to get the freeze to defense to make them think that it's an incompletion when it's not. And then the pass
to... You think so?
Yeah, I do. I do. I think purposely you throw it low so the defense is thinking it's an incompletion when it's really just a lateral.
That was way too low, but
Yeah, see, he threw it right at his feet. I think that was on purpose.
To his feet? Did it hit the ground the first throw? I don't think he...
I think he purposed it was a lateral, so I think he purposely threw it low to try to get the defense to kind of pause.
Right. Well,
and then Kyle's job was to pick it up and throw it to him.
You.
And had he done it, they might have scored
you.
A touchdown.
You're exactly right.
But it didn't work.
Didn't work.
So now the Packers on offense at the 28-yard line. Schenker in motion behind the line, and now they'll try to run some clock here. Leggett. He just had the 55-yard touchdown run a few minutes ago. That is the difference in the game right now to put the Packers on top 42-35.
Rush Probst knows what butters his bread. He went back to the exact same outside zone play there that where the success was.
They have two timeouts remaining here. I'm guessing you use it on the next play, right?
Yes.
And then you use it on the next play.
Yep. Got to get a stop here, though.
And it's unfortunate that they had to burn a timeout there on that fourth down play, but they wanted to set something up. And it, like I said, it looked like it would have worked, but they just didn't execute it. Carry right there by Edwards. And that's going to be a timeout call by the Vikings. That stops the clock with 1:46. And they have one timeout remaining. Nelly?
All right, we're going to kick it, but once again, we're going to do it a little differently. We're going to do the short version. We've talked about how Houston County is on the ropes tonight, needed to win tonight, and needed some help. Well, here's the answer once I turn my phone back on. There's the scoreboard from Freedom Field. The large number goes to Houston County, beating Northside 45-35. Valdosta next week comes to Freedom Field, and it's win, and you're in for Houston County. Jake Fromm. And the Hoco Locos have a life in Game 10. Back upstairs.
All right, Nelly.
Good job, Nelly.
Appreciate it, buddy. So now we're down to our final 1 minute and 46 seconds. The Vikings have one timeout left. It's a third down and 3. So if they stop them here, they're going to have a little life left. If the Packers get a first down, the game's over.
Yeah, and right here, I mean, you got to run the ball, punt it, and play defense if you don't get the first down. Because think about it. Lowndes hasn't done anything really still with their arm. They're going to have to make some they're not going to be able to run the ball because they won't have any more timeouts. They'd be forced to throw the ball. So I'm expecting a run here, but and play some defense by here from Colquitt.
Third down and 3. Here's your game. Hand off Edwards, and Edwards up to the 38-yard line, 39. If he got across the 39, the game's over. And that is a first down, and the Packers can finish this one off. Colquitt County now just 1 minute and 31 seconds away from their third consecutive region championship. And a big run by Dejon Edwards to move the sticks when they needed it most. And Saunders will take a knee back at the 32-yard line, and the Vikings will use their last timeout.
Tough run sticking his face down in there, dropping those shoulders, driving those legs by Edwards. That was a tough run. He wasn't going to be denied.
Well, be sure to join us next Friday night. It's going to be our Football Friday in Georgia Inside Edition, a full 4 hours of the final night of the regular season. We'll have comprehensive coverage of the playoff picture across the state as the teams wrap up their regular seasons. We'll have interviews with all the big-time coaches in the state of Georgia. We'll be looking at the brackets and looking ahead to the start of the state playoffs 2 weeks from tonight.
Lots of kicking it with Nelly. Full blast for you, Nelly.
And that's next
Full
Friday
blast
night.
Nelly. Is that a hashtag now?
Full blast. Nobody knows football. Come on, you're a guru. Come on, man.
Spell guru.
The best. You know what I mean.
G-O-O-R-O-O. Guru.
Yeah. So what you trying to say?
G-O-O-R-O-O. Guru.
Hey, I'll take a compliment from hashtag Dr. Rush any day of the week.
You're doing a good job. Great insight on the sideline today, Nelly.
Vikings have no more timeouts. Saunders takes a knee, and that's going to do it. So now it is going to be third down. Play clock has not been reset just yet, and the game clock continues to run. And let's see, they're probably going to have to snap it one more time.
Yep.
There goes the play clock. They'll have to snap it once more.
Other action out of Gwinnett. Mill Creek is the region champ, and it looks like Mountain View is in at 4-2. North Gwinnett, Collins Hill, and Peachtree Ridge fighting for 3, 4, and 5 in that region. Three teams, two spots. We're going to see a lot of that next week.
Yep. Everybody positioning for the playoffs.
And Saunders takes a knee for the final time. That will do it.
And let's see if we get a smile. Rush gave a smile. Whoa. Congratulations, Colquitt County. Also, congratulations to the Lowndes. Excellent game. We wish everybody could be a winner, but Colquitt finishes it out.
Packers will take a 6-game winning streak into the playoffs. They started 0-4, they've won 6 in a row, and they snap the Lowndes Vikings winning streak at 8 games here tonight as the Vikings wrap up the regular season at 8-2, and they'll go into the playoffs as a number 2 seed. Colquitt County with a big 55-yard touchdown run from Ty Leggett with 5.5 minutes remaining, survives here against Lowndes tonight, 42-35. Again, join us in studio next Friday night. We'll have the entire GPP team in studio for Football Friday in Georgia Inside Edition. For Chuck Smith, I'm Matt Stewart. The postgame show is coming up next. We send it down to John Nelson.
Early in the year, when you and I were talking about the two sections of this schedule, there was a word that you used, survival. You got through that first section. Now in the second section, it's another survival moment tonight.
No question. I mean, you know, first half, we could do about what we wanted to. You got to give them credit, Lowndes credit. Second half, David Shores, who worked for me at Hoover, by the way, for 3 years, he did a great job defensing us the second half to hold us to a touchdown. You got to give Randy McPherson a lot of credit for giving his team a rallying point to come back in the second half, and they just whipped our butt in the third quarter, and then we just survived at the end. The Leggett run is as good as it gets, but all I can say is this, Lowndes is a proud program. There's two good football teams out here battling tonight, and we just had one more play than they did. That's it.
So where are you right now as a team, do you think?
You know, I don't know. I know we're still growing as a team. We really wanted this win bad. There's no doubt about it, but you got to give credit where credit's due, and that's to the players, the assistant coaches. I know we stunk it up some in the third quarter, but I think a lot of that had to do with Lowndes, not us. I think they're a proud program. They're 8-1. They had us on the ropes. They get the two-point conversion down there. And I'm going to tell you what Randy was going to do. If they score and we don't hold them, and they score, he's going to go for two again to try to win the game.
Right.
So we had to keep him out, and I was proud of our defense on that last drive. You know, we just made one more play than Lowndes. That's it. No more, no less. I mean, I give a lot of credit to the Lowndes. I give a lot of credit to our players for finding a way to win the game.
Congratulations. Go celebrate.
Let's go celebrate. And then we got next week off. Thank goodness we knew. See you on the 11th.
All right. Post-game show continues in a bit. We're going to grab Jay Saunders for the Komatsu Forklift Player of the Game.
We are live here in Moultrie, Georgia at MacTharp Stadium. What a region championship game.
Wow.
Right down to the wire, 42-35 Colquitt over Lowndes.
That's what you love to see, and what resiliency Lowndes showed. I mean, they were in it the entire time. They fought really hard the entire time. A really great ball game. That's what you always expect in games like this.
All right, let's check out the highlights from today's game, and there were a lot of them in a high-scoring matchup. First quarter, it is Jay Saunders looking to find somebody. He finds Josh Hadley open in the corner of the end zone, and this gave Colquitt County a 21-7 lead. Later, it's Jay Saunders. He finds Torrey Parker open right in the corner of the end zone, 28-7. It's all Colquitt County. Second quarter still, Michael Barrett. He runs in, number one, 17-yard, cuts that Colquitt lead to 28-14. Right before the end of the first half, Jay Saunders, 3-yard run. It's 35-14 Colquitt at the half, but the third quarter is all Lowndes. Michael Barrett, 9 yards, makes it 35-21. Then it's Tyson Harris, makes it 35-28. They go for the two-point conversion, and they get the two-point conversion to cut that lead to 35-29. Then it's Michael Barrett. He makes it 35-35. And then here's your game winner, Ty Leggett. He goes 55 yards with the game-winning touchdown as the Packers win the Region 1 7-8 championship 42-35. Everybody played very hard tonight.
Yeah, don't tell me there's not heart in this game. Both teams. Huge, huge win for Colquitt, but a really good hard-fought game.
Let's check in with John Nelson. He's got the Komatsu forklift player of the game.
And it is QB3. You were getting your groove on there just a second ago. What was this week of prep like? I know that Jackie came down and talked to you earlier in the week, but what was it like knowing that this game was as big as it was?
Well, Lowndes is always a big game, and this time it was for the region championship, and we had a great week of preparation this week. The guys were ready. We were focused, had a great week in the weight room, and I really liked the plan coming into it tonight. Coach Hammond did a great job. The offensive staff did a great job, and we just came out and executed tonight.
When this offense is floating, that's probably the best word that I can use, is that this offense floats. Describe what it's like when everything's going full song.
Right, when everybody's doing their job, and that's our motto in the weight room, do my job. And whenever we're all doing that, we're hard to stop. And we showed that tonight in the first half. Second half, not so much, but in the first half we did.
All right, so let's talk about the third quarter. With this, I got one more question here. Let's talk about that third quarter. It starts with the onside kick, and time of possession was all them, and it felt like the field tilted a little bit. What was the vibe like on the sideline?
I just kept walking up and down, telling the O-line on the right side and the receivers, we're good, we're good. I got y'all. I'm going to make a play. And they trusted me, and I'm glad they did because – worked out pretty well for us.
All right, time for the presentation. Riley Wire, thank you very much. Actually, let me turn this around so I can actually, it's not reversed. Komatsu forklift player of the game. This means QB3 gets the hardware, so that goes with your towel. You get to keep the towel, and you get to keep the trophy. Thanks for hanging out with us all week.
Thanks, sir. Pretty good birthday present. Birthday's tomorrow, so.
See, there you go. See? And Jackie just wished you a happy birthday.
Well, I appreciate it, Miss Jackie. Sorry about the miss. It's a habit.
Miss Jackie.
I'll send it
back to the set before this goes anyplace else.
I appreciate that. I really do. I appreciate that. That means his mom raised him right. I like that. All right, let's get to our last few social media tweets. We had our poll going on all night long. Apparently, everyone spoke early on, and that was not going to change. 71% said Colquitt County would win this ball game. Then we have our friend Lee watching all the way from Las Vegas, a Colquitt County Packers fan. And then we just love this photo. Thanks to Rebecca for sending this. JJ Peterson with a little small fan here. So cute. And then we have Larry chiming in with this little fan celebrating a Packers touchdown. And then we have another fan watching saying, what a game. Those who have tuned out should tune back. Yeah, we would second that. So thanks for hanging out with us on social media. Don't forget to hang out with us next week as well. Now, speaking of JJ Peterson in that photo, he actually is our play of the game. So let's get to that. And this came early on. Huge play by JJ Peterson. Let's call it a kick six, a kickoff return for a touchdown. Nobody around him. He runs, finds the open space down the sideline. Weaves and bobs, but I mean, aside from all that, what a powerful runner. And that would actually give Colquitt their first points on the board, tie it up at 7 early on in the game. So the play of the game goes to JJ Peterson.
Thanks, Miss Jackie. Let's check out the Georgia EMC scoreboard. Lots of big, important games from all around the state. We start off with top-ranked Roswell. No trouble with Woodstock. 59-7, your final there. Grayson leads Hoover, Alabama. Rush Probst, old stomping grounds, 29-14 late in the fourth quarter. It is Norcross winning that region title over Brookwood, 21-0 a final. Valdosta over Coffey, 15-10 that game in the fourth quarter. Houston County remains alive. They beat Northside Warner Robins by 10, 45-35. In the fourth, it is Mays leading Alexander in a huge game there, 31-28. Elsewhere around the state of Georgia, we've got Glenn Academy, no trouble with Effingham County, 48-0. Buford in 4A or 5A over Loganville, 35-10. It is Stockbridge over Jones County, 35-14. That game in the fourth. Thompson leads Burke County, or has beaten Burke County, 20-7. Your final score there. It is Jefferson over Stevens County, 35-7. And Benedictine, top-ranked in Class AA, over Metter, 50-0. Well, we've had quite a game here tonight, but of course, Colquitt County now in a position to go for a three-peat, three in a row. They won back-to-back state championships last year when they knocked off Roswell. Let's take a look back in our Wayback Machine for the call on this one.
Welcome you inside the Georgia Dome for the Georgia High School Association 6A championship game. The defending state champion and 14-0 Colquitt County Packers take on the 14-0 Roswell Hornets. Season. Neely goes to the air to the far side. It's caught. It's going to go. 81 yards on the second play of the game. A.J. Smith, who caught the game-winning touchdown with just 10 seconds left against Grayson last Friday night, gets the Hornets on the board just 46 seconds into this game. And now Kiel Pollard out of their Wild Hog formation takes the direct snap, stiff arms his man, and pulls his way into the end zone. Pollard gets hit and still gets in. Xavier McKinney, the safety who's committed to Alabama, hit him in the backfield and still couldn't stop him.
That's great.
Parrish goes up top. Ty Lee with a spectacular touchdown catch. And Colquitt County has taken a 20-10 lead, and they have set a new Georgia State scoring record at the same time. Luis Martinez, he has 31 career field goals. He is 31 of 45 in his career. He has two field goals from tying the state record for field goals in a career. And this is a 31-yard attempt. And the kick is on its way, and it is good. And Rush Probst's team, currently ranked number two in the nation, they're going to be number one in the state of Georgia. Locked down in the next 84 seconds. It'll be the third state championship in Colquitt County history. And we're talking about a long history, folks. Over 100 years of football going back to the days of the Moultrie High School Packers. And this is for the record. Rush Probe's going to give Luis Martinez a chance to set the state record for career field goals, a 42-yard attempt. And it is good.
Another record.
Luis Martinez now holds the record for most field goals in a career. That is career field goal number 34.
And, you know, we saw earlier the Lowndes High School Marching Band, and now the Colquitt County Packers, the 50th Regiment, their band is performing right now. So we're going to listen into this performance brought to you by Regions Bank. And it actually is streaming live on our Facebook page. So you can find that through Facebook Live, and you can also see Lowndes from earlier. This is actually the Colquitt County 50th Regiment performing. Now we're going to send things over to John Nelson, who's keeping an eye on the Alexander and Mays game. And, John, it's down to the final few minutes, is it not?
Yeah, and we're going back and forth in this one, Jackie, as we kick it. We are 21 games tonight that can decide region champs. Four of the games have one versus two, and this is one of those one versus two matchups. Winner begins the gets the region championship. The loser gets the two seed. So let's see what's been going on with this one. Going back and forth, they've been trading blows. This one has gone from 28-24 Alexander halfway through the third quarter to 1 minute and 40 seconds left in the third. Mays ends up 31-28. So that was where we had it last, at 31-28 late third quarter for Mays. And let's take a look at other final scores from the evening and let you know what's been going on as to who gets to play for one more game as well. Benedictine, they roll tonight, beating Metter by the score of 50-0. Buford had a tough test with Loganville tonight, so they're in the driver's seat in their region, beating Loganville 35-10. Cairo, a big winner tonight over Columbus, 42-6. Dalton over South Cobb, 42-0. So let's kick it and show you what's going on with Mays and Alexander. And there's your update right now, under about 100 seconds to go regulation. And Mays is leading 31-28. This game being played at Lakewood Stadium, and the ball is at the 40-yard line. So there has to be some action here going on quickly. So it looks like 90 seconds, and no one in a hurry. So this is big on a second down and eight. It looks like it's about a third down and eight now, as we're coming up on 75 seconds to go. All Mays is looking for here is a way to hang on to the lead. And it looks like an off-tackle play just to get a couple of yards and see what else is moving on there. So once again, that looks like a timeout called with a minute four to go. And that's going to stop the clock there. 64 seconds. Mays leading Alexander 31-28. While they're in a timeout, let's go through some other finals. East Coweta, a winner tonight over Campbell, 42-14. Fitzgerald, a big winner over Early County, 40-6. Jefferson now in the driver's seat in their region, winning 35-7 over Stevens County. Kell, a winner tonight over Woodland Cartersville, 42-14. Mary Persons, playing in game 10 next week, is for the region championship after their 49-7 win over Perry this evening. Norcross shuts out Brookwood. Norcross is going to be the region champ with their 21-0 win over Brookwood. North Gwinnett over Collins Hill, 41-7. So next week in that region, three teams, two playoff spots. North Gwinnett, Collins Hill, Peachtree Ridge going for two spots with those three teams. Northgate a winner tonight over Hughes. Oconee County a winner. Parkview rebounds after the Battle of Five Forks Trickham, beating Meadow Creek 49-7. Other winners tonight: Pepperell big, Pickens big, Ridgeland big, Ringgold big, Rome over Woodstock 59-7, Sandy Creek big, Screven big, South Gwinnett hangs on over Archer 15-14. Now let's go back to Mays and Alexander live and duck in after the timeout is there. We keep reading some finals as we see plays develop there. Stevenson went over MLK 41-12. And you see what's been going on here with less than a minute to go. Less than a minute to go, Mays leading Alexander once again 31-28. Incomplete pass there, long, at Lakewood Stadium. So it looks like Mays is trying to hang on here as well. Once again, this is 1-2. Winner will be the region champ. Loser is the two seed coming in. St. Pius, Mark and Jackie, one of the big stories from the evening, came into the game at 0-8. This was a turnover on downs, it looks like. So it looks like, that barring something is going to happen, 31-28 right now, Mays will keep an eye on that. And if we go off the air, check the GPB Sports app with all your finals. We talked about St. Pius in the open, 0-8, playing North Oconee, also 0-8. St. Pius wins tonight. So if they win next week at 2-8, they're in the playoffs. And they've played one of the toughest schedules in their class, 1-8. They win, they're in the playoffs at 2-8 next week. And
I would say Coach Paul Standard would have the best 2-8 team in the state.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's also one more note from the coast. Jenkins gets their first region championship on the coast in Savannah since Super Bowl I was played.
Wow.
So congratulations to Jenkins tonight on the coast for their first region title in a very long time.
Okay, that wraps up things tonight from Moultrie, Georgia and MacFarb Stadium. The Region I champion has been decided.
Next week, is hard to believe, is the last Friday of the regular season, and many region championships from all over the state will be decided.
Yep, so we've decided to be the perfect time for another edition of Inside Edition, Inside Georgia, in the studio.
And we'll have all the highlights and drama all over the state. We'll get ready for the first week of the playoffs as the postseason kicks into high gear. I can't believe it.
It's almost here. So for all of us here at GPB Sports, thank you for watching tonight. We've had a great time. We thank all the folks here at Moultrie, all the folks at Colquitt County High School. Very friendly, very hospitable, as always. It was a great victory tonight for the Packers. A tough loss for Lowndes, who played a great, great game and a great second half. 42-35 is your final there. So for all of us here from the set here in Moultrie, we wish you a good night. We'll see you next week in the studio as we wrap up the regular season. So long, everybody.